Anyway, Tony Pandoloresco is here. He's in Canada. We got some sound that'll work. And it is the 14th of September. He's just a guy that knows a lot of stuff about health and things. And he sent me some new links that he's put up. Wow, you've been hard at work here, kid. You've got some new stuff, new videos, huh?
We got a new video out on grounding. We put out, what I did was on the webpage, I put in there some of the YouTube recipes. I'm starting on that because we're now going to play catch up on 140 videos plus. And so the new links that are inside, I'm also putting in there future videos that we're going to be doing. And the one I've done so far is the anti-nano. That one will be a work in progress. I've been adding to it. So if anybody goes to the website, you know, the augmentedforce52webs.com website, and they clicks on the YouTube recipe, then they look at the anti-nano. I'm showing you how to build an anti-nano chamber. I'm showing you how to build something for your food. I've done some my own investigation research, and I've got pictures of about seven different foods, like fruits and whatnot, as far as what's inside the nano. Your potatoes, your apples, your plums. If you eat those, you have to peel off at least an eighth of an inch off the top, or else you're going to be consuming them. If you're eating any banana, which I don't endorse, but bananas are loaded with the nano, so you have to peel them and take off an eighth of an inch off of that. Cherries and peaches, forget it. They're saturated to the core. So the only thing you can do there is you'd have to juice them and put them through a, this again, what I call the anti-nano chamber or degaussing component to get the nanoparticles out. Then again, filter it through a, fish tank filter. Those, those little filters that use to filter the water. And it was the other one. And the New Zealand kiwi was good. You peeled it, and they didn't see any signs of the nano penetration in there. Last night I was doing apple juices that I bought from the store and black currants that I got from the European market and wine. And when I did the anti-nano with the black currant, all kinds of stuff started surfacing to the top. And I filtered it through, and it seemed fine. The apple juice, pure juice from the store, loaded. It made a scum. Now, I haven't put these pictures up yet, but I will be. It made a scum, which I, again, had to scoop out and then filter to the fish tank aquarium filter. And then last night I tried wine. Same thing. The wine was, all of a sudden, the stuff started coming up to the surface and saturating. The way I'm looking at it now, you're going to have to be a little bit more, facetious with the, or not facetious, more comprehensive in how you're going to clean your food, because you can't get this stuff out. The stuff does penetrate on some, and again, I haven't checked everything out, but even if, don't assume because it's grown underground or it's got a thick skin, this stuff doesn't penetrate. It does. And so depending on how much or how far. The cherries I let soak in trisodium phosphate and sodium borax solution for 12 hours. It didn't even touch it. I even used a brush to try to brush the stuff, and again, nothing. And again, I got pictures of that as well online.
So you're talking about nanoparticles, and why do you believe that these things are dangerous?
Not because of what I believe, the research on it. Every research and investigation I've got from the military to the industrial, none of them advocate these things at all. In fact, a lot of people that are selling these so-called devices that are going to stop the nano, none of them will work, because what happens is when they do an investigation on the nanoparticles on a nano level, you got to say nano gold, for instance, or nano silver. None of the particles are exactly like. They're all different. They're all different sizes, different shapes, different dimensions. And then when you start getting into the system, they cluster. Now, when they get into a cell, it's not one particle getting into a cell. It's thousands getting into a cell. So anything that you're using nano will actually supersaturate your cells and accelerate the oxidation process of the cells, breaking down the ATP levels, breaking down the mitochondria. They don't work with us at all. And all this research, everyone's reading about how they're using it in the medical field and whatnot. They're only giving you one aspect of that equation. What they don't tell you is they don't get these things don't come out, and how they get lodged, where they get lodged, like in the brain, heart, spleen, skeletal structure, liver, kidneys. This stuff basically literally rewrites your DNA, rewrites your chromosomes, rewrites your genetic code. They are so small, they can act just like a viral, fungal, bacterial. We even got pictures on that site, the anti-nano site, where if you go in there and you look at the pictures, how you can be very easily misdiagnosed with a Lyme, for instance, or a mold or a bacterium or whatever. Because the medical field, if they don't know what to look for, or don't know even of the aspect of the nano poisoning that's going on, will be misinterpreting the symptomologies as a biological pathogen, because the nanoparticles are what they call mimetics. They can actually mimic the actual effect of some of the things, and they have a morphology to them where they, again, grow, advance. They'll start off as ribbons, wind up as tubes, fibers, filaments, chips, wrapped up proteins, if you will, because they do use your cells, they use your sugars, they use your fats. They are programmable. They will, again, follow their paradigm that they've been programmed to follow, and they will self-replicate and self-assemble inside the system. So what happens is anything you take in regard to a form of chelation or whatever will reduce it to somewhat, but then the moment you drink, eat, or eating any of the, especially the high vegetable content in fruit because of the cellulose in it, is the way it attaches itself to that, it will reload in the body, and so then you start the process all over again. So basically, I was looking at some of the stuff, came across some research, decided to experiment with it, and it seems to be working. I have another group of people in Colorado that tried it, said that wounds that wasn't healing because of the nano or the Morgellons that they're only calling, all of a sudden started healing again. When you put your body into it, I got a bucket that I show you how you make it, and you wrap it up with wiring, and you run a power supply to it. What happens is there, as soon as you put your legs in it, and you add the vinegar and the salt and water to it, you'll see the particles just literally lift out of your legs and lower extremities. And that's where a lot of people are suffering a huge amount of pain, because this is where a lot of the nanoparticles are accumulating in the lower extremities, because the immune system is trying to push it away from the organs. And again, if you do it for a couple of days, you can notice a significant lightness in your extremities, and you can the way you walk and how you feel. And then if you do it and take a bath in a saline solution, you see that what comes out of the body is almost doubles.
So, Tony, why do you suppose that small amount of people are being affected by this? Why would that be?
Not a small amount. Everybody's being affected by it. It's just that it's that. What happens is it reaches a certain saturation point, and everybody reaches it sooner or later. And when it does, that's when you start seeing some of the symptomologies.
Are you saying that everybody in the world will have some symptoms of this someday?
There's no doubt. No doubt. They're spraying glyphosates on everything. And if you look at glyphosates, they're using what they call nanoadjuvants.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what happens with nanoadjuvants is when you spray it on a crop, it doesn't just hit the surface of the crop. It penetrates right to the very core of its genetic code and goes right to this root, to the root structure. And so what's happening is the very biology of the plant now has been completely altered, and so is the soil. I mean, if you, I don't know about you where you are, because again, you don't see chemtrails and things, which I do see here.
Mm-hmm.
But what happens here is we have not seen butterflies. Bee population is way down. We've lost over 70 million bees. I haven't seen but one bee this year. We've got a lot of wasps flying around.
Well, that's good. You know, I don't think you're alone in that regard. I think we've heard reports all over the world, essentially. Of course, the bee issue, the bat issues, the butterflies,
monarch,
right?
This is a monarch haven where I live.
The white, what is it, Tony? The white fungus on the bats is a big problem. I don't know what that connected to, but we certainly have had our years with zero wasps, but they seem to be coming back. I'm seeing nests around where I haven't seen them for years. We saw lightning bugs here, Tony, for the first time in 10 years. So it seems like there's, I don't know. You know, interesting about glyphosates, we had a pretty interesting story, Tony, that came out yesterday. California just dealt Monsanto a pretty big blow under the Safe Drinking Water and Toxic Enforcement Act, Proposition 65, chemicals that cause birth defects and other reproductive harm are required to be listed and published by the state. In March, they listed, now they're listing glyphosate as a known carcinogen which causes birth defects and cancer and stuff.
Are they also recording atrazine, because that is even more severe than the glyphosate?
Well, I don't know. This is just a story on glyphosate.
Okay, because again, if they're not listing the atrazine, which is even worse, and you got to remember, it's not just Monsanto. Monsanto is the one that's been targeted. You still have Syngesta, you have Symbis, you have Cargill, AGM, you have DuPont, Dow, Nestle's, you know, you got BASF. They're all contributing to this. And
well, this is on glyphosate atrazine, and not, this is an article about glyphosate, not Monsanto.
I'm just elaborating a little bit further.
Gotcha.
Okay, when you're talking atrazine here, atrazine is so, it's even just as, if it's not as dangerous, it's more so because of the way, how it affects the endocrine system. It alters the, not only the genetic makeup, it alters the endocrine system. So if you're a heterosexual, it'll alter you into a homosexual because that's how it alters the system.
I hate it when that happens.
Well, yeah, you know, I'm not fond of it either. So when we're looking at some of the issues on the whole homosexual front, see, what they've done over the years is they've covered this up by creating a dynamic there where you've got to treat homosexuals now as an equal and all this other stuff. But they're not dealing with the fact that they altered these people through experimentation with these chemicals, and now they're not doing anything to fix these people. So now everybody has to accept the damage that these bio-agro companies have created. And it's going right down the line. And it's an atrocity on every level. And it's not just happening in the United States. It's happening in Canada. It's happening in South America. It's happening in Europe. It's happening in Russia. It's happening in China. It's happening all over. And then we're reading all these accounts about how, you know, Russia's not going to be growing genetically modified foods. They're growing it now and selling it to Europe, same in the Ukraine. So when you're talking these issues, the nano part of this, okay, is even more dangerous because it not only adheres and integrates itself with the biology, it augments the biology or destroys the biology, depending on how you want to look at it, to exasperate your immune system on a whole different level. So, like I said, we created this thing. We're showing you how to restore the ATP levels because you've got to restore the ATP levels back in the system. You got to restore the mitochondria back as well, and you got to start dealing with removing the glyphosates from the body as well because it doesn't break down. The bacteria in your colon will not break it down, can't break it down. And in fact, the glyphosates actually flush out the bacteria in the colon. So you're going to need to take things like phosphorus with minerals, sulfur with minerals, and you have to use these things in conjunction with bacteria because, getting rid of this stuff is key. The sodium thiosulfate or the SDS will do wonders at flushing out a lot of the buildup of the glyphosates in the system.
Oh, does it?
It does. It will help with that a lot.
Okay, let's go to your website a minute and tell folks. Let's give them some help here on where to find this if they're interested. Now, if we go to Augment in Force.
Okay, go to Augment in Force.
.50webs.com. Now, then you go to the home page. So it's got all these things are in blue, underlined.
Okay, so
would be the ATP thing, which increases ATP?
You scroll down to get to the part where you got the links. Okay,
yep.
And then look at the left side, follow us. You'll see recipes for the YouTube vids. Click on that.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Recipes for the YouTube vids. I see. Oh, now mine's not clickable recipe. Oh, yeah, it is. I've got them. Copper, glyco. Those are all the recipes, right?
I'm trying to, hold on, I just got hit with a bug here.
Top of the page, recipes for the YouTube videos. Yeah, I see the AT activator formulas, okay.
Click on that, so okay. When you're looking at the...
I see, okay. You got them all listed here.
That, then there's anti-nano.
Yeah.
The next thing you'll look at, the next page is anti-nano, so you click on that.
Mm-hmm.
Then what happens is when you click on the anti-nano, because mine decides to work for me. Then what will happen is you'll see the anti-nano, the chamber. I'm showing you a bucket that's wrapped up with about 96 wrappings of wire. Holy crap. This was supposed to be worked on. Then, again, I show you formulas, what to put in the solution to help you, again, pull the nanoparticles out. Okay, and then... Then below, you'll see what I've got shown there is nanomimetics, because nanoparticles will mimic biological agents. And you can see the pictures there in regard to the photos. And also, you can see how the nanoparticles inside the body will start to aggregate, accumulate, and start to grow in the system. Okay? Then what you do is, when you keep going down, you can see the fruits, some of the pictures of the fruits I've taken, Bosch pears. I mean, not only was it loaded with the nanoparticles, but you can see that the biofilm inside had become completely, it was taken over from the inside out. The cherries, if you look at them real close, you'll see the, what looks like it's been hit with a bomb kind of thing, and these are all particulates. I've got an apple where I've actually circled and triangulated showed you the triangles that was forming because of the self-assembling process. I've got the peaches that look like you can see that the nanoparticles, again, are self-assembling and growing on the skin. I've got several peaches. I've got the banana, I've got the pear. And if you keep going down, I'm showing you there's a chamber there. Show you how to make a mini chamber. I used basically a flower vase and wrapped it up with about 80 wrappings. So then you put the liquids inside, and then I show you after I take it out of the chamber, I'm putting it in a bowl, and I'm using a fish tank filter to filter this out. I've lasted as long as a day to do it. And then below, I explain how to make it. And then below that, I'm showing you different things that you need to do to restore your body's cellular makeup and your tissue makeup by using liposomes, by using different type of polymer things that you can make at home, using pectin materials. Using colloidals, not nano, because colloidals are in a micron size. Micron your body can utilize and will get rid of. On a nano scale, all you do is accumulate, build up, and then cause severe levels of oxidation. And right after that, I've got what they call ATP activators. There's one formula there. And below that, I'm giving you some information on it, what it does. And then below that, I've got all kinds of... supplements and nutrients to help you build your ATP back. And because again, that's going to be crucial and key, because once you start using things like straight ATP or AMP or adenine or B2, B3, carnitine, CQ10, you will start noticing your vitality levels will definitely start to increase, and you'll start seeing yourself more alert. And below that, I show you how to repair your mitochondria, what to use, and things that will help, again, rebuild and restore it. The key minerals for your mitochondria would be zinc and manganese, and this is one of the things that the glyphosate exudes or excretes out of the system. So when you're looking at all these things that I've shown you here, and again, this will be a work in progress. I will keep on adding to this page because the information I'm digging in from the industry, I'm digging in from the... university studies and digging from the military studies. This has been going on for quite some time, at least 40 years. And a lot of this stuff is already in the environment. This is the problem. And there is no, there really isn't any legislation yet on this to regulate the waste byproduct. A lot of this is already out there. We're getting it from the chemtrails. You're getting dumped on literally. This is why you see some of the trees and plants reacting the way they do with these black spots or speckled particles. The trees and the plants are producing what they call a saponin, a soap-type material, so that it has a way of purging the stuff. So it takes, for instance, the maple trees here that have been affected, it has taken them like 4 or 5 years to produce the right saplin combination to remove the stuff from itself, but it still gets affected. A lot of the plants that you're seeing around you are probably dying and not returning. Like our peaches, for instance, have been blighted here. We don't really have any peach production anymore like we used to. So, again, when you look at this page, feel free to download it. You don't need a credit card. You don't need anything. Feel free to take it. At the very top of the page itself, there are links that you can just click on to take you to specific spots on the page. I think this is one that everyone should download. And the other one that we have is on the same YouTube recipe. It's called Nano Solutions. This is where we talk about taking the saline bath, what to put in your bath.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's take a little break. Thanks for all the work. He's an amazing amount of research. And you look at these pages, and he's got all kinds of, what do you call those things, Tony, when you give references
everything is right there.
Yeah, I mean everything's right there. So it's not like he's, you know, there's a lot of research that goes on here. It is augmentinforce, .50webs.com, Patrick Timpone, One Radio Network. One of the things that Tony mentioned and what we like to do is, and especially if you get some good minerals with it, the mineral magic, the minerals and the sulfur, and this organic sulfur, it comes from various places. We do get questions about what's the source of this and all that. Patrick, the sulfur guy who's in, I believe he's in Murray, Utah, Furry Murray, Utah, and what he does is he scouts around and he finds different sources of this just pure organic sulfur that's got no adjuncts, no tagalongs, no excipients, as they say in the biz. So it works. It'll actually make little crystals and stalagmites and stalactites in the bottom of a glass if you play with it overnight and know how to do it. So it's living, and they test it out before they do it, but they do get it at different places, not just one spot. People kind of always like to know the source, and so do we, but this is the best we can do with Patrick in Furry Murray, Utah. And what you do is you just, you can email him if you'd like to get more information. But that's about the best we know. But we know that it works. We know that people have good experiences. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of testimonials over the last 2 years that people just like it. And whether it's remembering their dreams or feeling less pain or just feeling overall a sense of well-being, all kinds of skin, hair, nails, all kinds of good things for a very, very reasonable price. Click and order, oneradionetwork.com, organic sulfur, three prices, three locations, United States, Canada, where Tony is, and worldwide. And then also, if you'd like more than 4 pounds, email me, Patrick@OneRadioNetwork.com. We give a discount for 4 pounds or more.
Awesome health can no longer be attained from food alone. Since the advent of chemical agriculture in 1945, U.S. soils have become progressively more demineralized and infertile. Human health has correspondingly declined. To reverse this trend and to even have a chance at feeling great requires sophisticated supplementation to make up for what is not in our foods. When our bodies are mineral deficient, they require more protein. We suggest you begin with One World Way. One World Way is a new and improved protein power food. Our technological enhancement yields us a whey protein that produces phenomenal results. All case histories indicate that your body functions in a more youthful manner. One World Way not only supports detoxification, building of lean muscle, and immunity, it strongly supports your energy and sense of well-being. One World Way tastes delicious and comes in single servings. You can click on the One World Way banner ad and order right here at OneRadioNetwork.com. That's OneRadioNetwork.com.
Just a little bonus for this product. You know, it's got this whole Tesla kind of Murray Moto kind of thing working too to make it happier, snappier, as well as very high in cysteine, which gets the old glutathione thing and keeps the liver makes glutathione, you know.
Healthy elimination is essential to high...
I beg your pardon. I didn't want to do that one. We just did that one.
SDL Incorporated and Andrew Goss are proud of building some of the best rare coin portfolios over the past 30 years. Every investor is directed to a numismatic broker to personally handle their account. Peace of mind about your investment is as important as profits. So call 1-800-468-2646 and receive information regarding the value of the dollar, how money is created, and also devalued over time. More importantly, how to protect your money and purchasing power in the coming years. Don't make any rash decisions. Learn properly about this unique opportunity, how to do it correctly. Call us today, 1-800-468-2646.
Okay, I think the Nikkei in Asia was down considerably last night. Yeah. And Europe is pretty even, steady, not much going on. Stock market opened up lower this morning, the Dow and the S&P and the NASDAQ. Oil is down. The dollar is up. Gold and silver are down a little bit. There you have it from Andy Goss's company, SDL Inc. Here's master herbalist Stephen Buhner on Sir Thrival Pine Pollen.
The pollen itself is extremely high in a number of male estrogens, the most potent of which is testosterone. And it's got a fairly high level of it. I mean, it's still in the micrograms, but that's really all the difference between us and women, is that we have this microgram more than they do, and then in the womb, that shifts us into the male developmental pattern. So when we start adding that stuff back in to our bloodstream, which you do if you take that sort of tincture and you hold it in your mouth for a while and then you swallow it without putting it in any water or anything, it goes right through the mucous membranes into the bloodstream, and so you start to get an increase in the body of actual testosterone, which then circulates to pretty much every cell in the body, and that then begins to increase vitality and muscle strength and everything else.
Pine pollen from Sir Thrival. It's strong. It works. Click and order all Sir Thrival links. Front page, OneRadioNetwork.com.
We talk about your health, wealth, and well-being on OneRadioNetwork.com. Patrick now, 888-663-6386, or email patrick@oneradionetwork.com.
He's just a guy up Canada way where the queen mom is keeping a short leash on Tony, just kidding, on Tony Pantalaresco, just a guy that knows a lot of stuff about healthy. You can see his YouTube videos, my goodness. He does quite a bit of research. Augmentinforce.50webs.com is the place where you can get a lot of the written material. He has scripts of his shows that he does. I was looking around, Tony. I saw your earthing and grounding piece here. And idea that Dave Stetzer gave us a couple years ago about the aluminum on the floor, kind of putting your feet on there to download, discharge you. And you had mentioned to me at one time that you thought copper would even, make that a little bit better. So I bought some thin copper sheets and I do that. One of our listeners was talking about it last Open Phone Friday and was kind of musing, well, what about stepping on aluminum or copper, and wouldn't it be absorbed through the bottom of the feet? And maybe that's not, maybe we should use something else like stainless steel.
You know what? That's sort of a overkill mess crap. The amount of copper, copper you need to absorb. If it absorbs through the skin, by all means, stand on it all day, you know.
Sure.
Same with the aluminum. You're only standing on it for, a minute or two?
Right, yeah, 30 seconds or a minute. Right.
So, I doubt very seriously you're going to absorb anything of any consequence that's going to be of value. And if you're really that afraid, and after you get done stepping on the copper, put your feet in some Epsom salt and magnesium, and the sulfur will pull it out of your body.
Well, stainless steel do the same thing if you don't want to step on the aluminum.
I don't think so, to be quite honest with you, because of the nature of what we're talking about. Because the way the frequencies are, copper, iron, and aluminum are the best way to go. I talk to people that work in this frequency business that work in an industry, and that's what Dave told me. If you're going to do anything like this, or even blocking frequencies, copper, iron, and aluminum are the thing to use. A lot of these devices are selling in the health food store where you wear a device and it's supposed to diffuse all these frequencies. They told me, they said, a lot of these things don't really work that well. And for one thing is, if you got two types of frequencies, high and low. They're not designed to disperse it, and the amount of space that they're covering on your body will not stop the full exposure. So basically, you're building up on it. So the moment you step on, like I said, I've done a copper aluminum where I've got copper on top of the aluminum.
Yeah.
You sit there, I'll tell you, after about, 10, 15 minutes, you just feel like jello. You're totally relaxed.
Oh, I've never stayed on that long. I'll try that.
You know.
I've never stayed on that
long. In front of your computer and you put your feet on that, you'll find that you won't feel the effects of the computer breaking you down. I mean, it's like it's hitting and going through you kind of thing. The other thing, too, like I said, if you're doing that nano thing, the anti-nano, and you make the bucket and you get a power supply. The power supply I'm using is basically a laptop power supply, 5 amps, 14-volt, 5-amp supply. And when you put the vinegar in the and the salt, I tweaked the formula. I add sodium EDTA with it as well, with salt and the citric, and I add citric acid because I want it to really penetrate the muscle tissue. I'll tell you, you sit there for about, after you get down about a half hour, everything from your knees down to your ankles feels like you've just dropped about 300 pounds. And the next day when you wake up, because a lot of people wake up with a lot of pain in the lower extremities, find that it usually takes about 3 days. This is what I found anyway. After the third day when you wake up, you feel your legs feel lots lighter. You're more mobile. If you've got any kind of, like I said, sores and stuff down in the lower extremities that don't seem to want to heal, all of a sudden they're starting to heal because, again, what's happened is the nanoparticulates are clustered down in the lower extremities, and so it's blocking any real blood flow or oxygen to the lower extremities.
The copper aluminum will deal with that?
Well, it'll discharge you, mm-hmm. and then the anti-nano bucket that I show you will further pull out the nanoparticles. So,
and where's the anti-nano bucket?
That's in that anti-nano link.
Oh, so you can't just take something orally to get rid of the nanoparticles in your legs.
You can use EDTA and sodium thiosulfate, which will flush out a lot of it.
Well,
like I said, the nature of nano isn't when we all get our head around the fact that this is not a solid material, but a clustering material. Okay, and they tell you about this in the research that when nanoparticles get around in the environment, whether it be in your environment internally or externally, they cluster, and this is the problem with them, is when they cluster, they concentrate the area of space they take. So what happens, they literally suffocate everything that they touch and or reorientate whatever they're around.
Hmm.
Okay, because they're using this, the nano silver, for instance, as a pesticide in the industry, the bugs that survive this are going to be altered on a genetic level.
Super bugs.
Huh?
They'll be super bugs.
Because, again, with the silver inside of them, again, it'll make them a lot harder to kill. So, we're talking a whole dynamic of science. And, again, I have become almost obsessed with this.
I can tell. That's
well,
okay. Somebody's got to. Somebody,
I'm not the only one.
No, I'm not criticizing you. I said, somebody's got to do it. So that's your job. Good job. Hey,
like I said, I'm collaborating with other people. I got another fellow of mine, Brian 396. He's also online on this, and he's got another fellow out there. And I think we're one of the few people that are really actually touching on this thing the way it's supposed to be touched. You've got a lot of people out there, and I'm going to warn everybody on this: do not go out there and buy devices or contraptions. I don't care if it's a spooky device or a rice machine that's going to deal, because it's not going to deal with this. The one thing that they found as well on this stuff, each nanoparticle oscillates. There's over 100,000 oscillations on these nanoparticles. So there's no way you can lock a signal on these things to try to do anything that they're saying. And if there is any relief or any effect on these devices, it's because the biofilm which is a secondary effect from the nano poisoning. It may be dealing with that aspect of it, but until the nano components come out, you're going to constantly repeat whatever therapy is going on. And I've had people contact me after using these things. They've spent literally tens of thousands of dollars on devices and contraptions, and none of them worked. And they're telling me that just the little things I'm showing them has done more for them than 10 years of therapies and whatever. And it's a simple little process. Anybody can make it. It's cheap. You know, what does a bucket run, a 5-gallon bucket run you down in, you know, in the U.S. or in Canada? Wire in Canada is expensive, and I'm using a 12-gauge wire. You can go to any computer shop and buy yourself a power supply for like $5 or $10, or go on, you know, Amazon or whatever and get one there. You know, and again, it's not hard to put together. We will be doing a video on it eventually, and we will be, again, expounding on this more through the video so that, you know, if there's any questions on this, we can hopefully cover it in the...
Okay. On the simple nano EDTA sodium thiosulfate, what would be the dosage as a formula on that one?
Like for oral use, you mean?
Yeah, for oral use on the EDTA and the sodium thiosulfate.
Just do what you normally do. You got to remember, your body can only take so much. So, I mean, more is not better in this situation. Don't go crazy. I'm telling you, use a teaspoon of sodium thiosulfate with ascorbic acid, again, to protect the liver. And again, if you watch the YouTube, people who have tried this, I mean, they're flabbergasted at the effect that they've had on it, how much better they feel. The EDTA, same thing. Again, if you're using these things, then you have to use a probiotic of some kind or some kind of fermented foods. And if you're going to take the minerals, I'd probably suggest mixing them in a liposome. Now, I'm going to talk about that real quick.
Okay.
I'm going to show you an easier way to make liposome. So easy, so simple.
Okay.
Takes you about 2 minutes.
Okay.
All you need is go into any health food store or online and order the powder sunflower lecithin. Don't get the gelatinous stuff. When we first did it, we showed you how to just mix it with the...
Right, yeah. You can get the powder sunflower lecithin.
So then what you do is you take your minerals or your vitamin C or whatever you want to put in there.
Okay.
Mix it in the powder, blend the powder together, add a little water, just enough, blend it up, whip it up. It will make liposome in about 2 minutes.
Now, wait a minute. So you're suggesting that this whole thing with the jewelry cleaner thing is not necessary?
It's not needed at all. If you want to do it that way, you can.
Right.
You get the powder. What a liposome is, and all a liposome is a bilayer of fat that surrounds a component.
Correct. And that's what the lecithin does, right?
So now what's happening is you're in the dry form. So now if you really want these things to, again, mix really well, get them in powder. So let's say you want to use acerola berry. Okay?
Acerola cherry, yeah, right.
You want to use that. You don't want to use the vitamin C. You've got some issue because it's a ascorbic acid, whatever the heck you've got. Okay, so take about a tablespoon, about 100 grams, which is about a little over 6 tablespoons, 6 tablespoons and 2 teaspoons of the powder.
Of the lecithin?
Of sunflower lecithin. So then you want to add, I don't care, you want to add 10 grams, 20 grams, add the 10 or 20 grams, mix it up. And add your powder, mix the powders up really well so that they're all mixed up.
Oh, 10 grams of acerola cherry, right.
Anything you want.
Okay.
10 grams, 20 grams, 30 grams, whatever you like.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, how much is that, like 1 or 2 tablespoons compared to the 6?
Yeah.
Okay.
1 tablespoon gives you 15 grams. So
okay.
I always keep it simple so that people can do the math on this stuff. So you use 10 grams of the one, 100 grams of the other.
Okay. 10 to 100. All right.
Okay.
Gotcha.
So it's 1/10 or 10%. Then what you do is you mix them up really well in the blender and then add water to it after you get done mixing them up, blend them up, and you've got the most perfect mix of a liposome.
So you're talking like a Vitamix or a blender?
Anything.
Now, anything. Can you, we've heard difference on this. Is there any way that you could substantiate this incredible claim that you're making here this morning, September 14th?
About what?
About what? Making a liposome that easy and quickly.
I got, you know what, if I haven't got it on my webpage yet, I
will. You got a little science behind it?
I did some research on this, and I went back to 1910.
Yeah?
This horse hockey they're putting out there is such rubbish. And again, it's about sales and whatnot. One guy, okay, when you're looking at liposomes, now, again, this can happen, just so that you are aware that this can happen.
Okay.
If you make a liposome and it does leak out, in other words,
separate.
You've got too much
of your
component with whatever you're mixing the sunflower lecithin with.
Right.
It's still a liposome, except what's happened is because you've got so much, it's leaked out. So all you need to do is add a little bit more powder to it until you get it saturated again, and you're right back in the saddle. So they've made a whole lot of hooey about nothing on this. And I find that, like I said, when I hear people like this, and, because nobody really researches this stuff or really knows where to look at this stuff, and I find this stuff all the time. And I go way back before all this stuff was a marketing ploy on this, and I see what's really going on. And that's all a liposome is. That's it. Simplest terms, you know. The other big thing that you're probably going to hear again or make a rebound again is something called glyconutrients.
Yeah, we've heard about those of recently, glyconutrients.
All it is the same thing. It's a sugar bound with a component, and they're using sugar as a delivery method. So it triggers either an insulin response or it gets absorbed in the liver in a certain way. So, again, you're supposed to uptake more of the nutrients. And, again, you're probably going to see this coming up the way. And the simplest glyconutrients you can make is mixing certain things, anything you want with glycerol. And, again, you're going to see a lot of this stuff pop up, or aloe vera. Because aloe vera is a big one because it's got 7 sugars or whatever.
So, now, wait a minute. So you're saying if you had something that you wanted to get lots in you easy, quickly, you can mix it with an aloe vera or a glycerol, and you have a glyconutrient.
Yeah, because it's all is the sugar. Okay, creatine.
That's all it is, right?
So let's go with creatine.
Creatine, yeah, for muscle guys, take creatine.
No, not just for muscle. It's for ATP production.
Oh, is it?
One of the best things you can do for ATP production as well, and it also has a very powerful brain protective effect.
Oh, we like that, okay.
So, what did they used to use back in the day? They were using grape juice or grapefruit juice. Now, when you did that, what it was doing was spiking the insulin levels up, and you were only getting 30%. So what they did to boost the ratio up to 100% or 99% or 95% is they added straight dextrose or white sugar. So basically they were combining the sugar with these amino acids to stimulate a stronger uptake. Now, I wouldn't suggest doing that because, again, you know, you wind up screwing up your pancreas if you don't take the proper like zinc and other things with it to regulate the insulin. But this is one of the things they used to use to get bodybuilders feeling like they're really powerful and strong and all this. They were doing basically was they were jacking up the ATP levels, which gave them the power that they were looking for to, again, increase mitochondrial strength.
Can you get clean, like a pure, clean creatine of some kind?
Yeah. I've never changed. All this crap with this nitric oxide boosting creatine.
Right.
A lot of horse hockey with that, too. Creatine is a combination of 3 amino acids, glycine, arginine, and methionine.
Okay.
And what glycine and arginine also do, if you took creatine before going to bed, it would produce what they call a growth hormone response. So, again, it's another simple little thing. You can, instead of buying these $200
muscle-building things, yeah?
Muscle-building things for producing growth hormone, this will do it all on its own.
And how would you know, Tony P., if the creatine is, you just look at the label and make sure it's just pure creatine?
Well, it'll say micronized creatine or creatine monohydrate.
And that's okay.
You'll have to kind of look at the source.
Okay.
On it. The stuff made in the United States is pure. The stuff made in Germany is pure. At one point, they were saying the stuff coming from China had contaminants. I really, really, really doubt it, to be quite honest with you. I've been buying directly from the China, because all your supplement companies are buying direct from China when they manufacture these products. So I don't really see a problem with that. I think what they've done is they created this hysteria so that people won't buy direct and bypass the buyers. It's a lot of bullshit all the way around.
Bolshoi, like the Bolshoi Ballet, right?
Yeah, Bolshoi. Let me say the other word.
No, I won't. Because, see, once you go to the Bolshoi Ballet, Tony, and you've seen it one time and you go back, every year it's the same old Bolshoi. I mean, I don't know. So do you have a brand of creatine that you can recommend?
Basically, I mean...
Like somebody could go on Amazon.
Creatine monohydrate. Now, again, you'll sometimes see the term micronized.
Okay.
You don't have a problem with, because it's on a micron level, which means it's in a millionth measurement. Your body will utilize it and not get oversaturated and either pee it out or crap it out. Okay. And you don't have to do the stupid thing that they used to tell you. They used to tell you you had to take 20 grams a day for 5 or 7 days and go down to 1 teaspoon a day.
Yeah.
That's a lot of horse hockey. Again, it was a lot of sales. It would get you to use the stuff up faster. All you need to do is 1 teaspoon. I mean, you can take as much as you like, but 1 teaspoon a day. You can mix it in coffee, which is the other crazy. Oh, don't mix it in coffee. It has blah. The first studies that were done on creatine were done with coffee, and they saw results with the coffee. So, again, do not get caught up in that whole hokey-pokey. Just make sure that the coffee, when you're drinking it, it's black. Don't add cream or anything else to it, because that will impede the uptake. And make sure that the creatine is completely dissolved. If it's not completely dissolved, you will get gas, and you will have intestinal duress. So, again, make sure it's dissolved properly. If you don't want to use coffee, that's fine. You can put it in tea or warm water, which is what I would suggest. And if you want to add a little maple syrup to it, or you want to add a little glycerol to it, there's your sugar to spike it up. And, again, make sure you're getting adequate amount of zinc, adequate amount of potassium, adequate amount of manganese to regulate the insulin in the body. Or make sure you take it with juniper berry or cinnamon extracts, again, to regulate the insulin.
And the benefits of folks experimenting with creatine are?
Number one, ATP. Let's go there.
Okay, that gets the energy. If you feel down in the mouth, maybe you'll feel up in the mouth.
That will stimulate ATP production, which is your energy production in the body.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I probably would tweak that a little bit by adding vitamin B2 or riboflavin or B3, any form of niacinamide would work. But B2 and B3 are both ATP producers. You might want to order something called adenine, A-D-E-N-I-N-E, which is vitamin B4. Now, some of these sites will say vitamin B4 is choline. That's not accurate. Vitamin B4 is something called adenine. That's part of the ATP production. If you want to add a little trisodium phosphate with your creatine and some adenine, you can do that as well, because now you've got all the components there to stimulate high levels of ATP production, which, again, will stimulate mitochondrial strength. All of a sudden you feel your loins and your legs and your mid everywhere feeling stronger. You become more resistant to the nano poisoning. Everybody has it. There is no one on this planet that hasn't been exposed to some form of nanoparticles, whether it's through cosmetics, whether it's through some of the supplements or food you're eating. Well, if you're eating food, you've been exposed through the air you're breathing, from the chemtrails, from the glyphosates and the atrazines and other pesticides are spraying in the fields, whether it's orgasmically organic or not, it's all got some kind of contamination. When you look at these pictures of the fruits that I've taken, these are supposedly coming from organic or farm-grown, local farm-grown stuff. So don't have any delusions about organics. And the other lunatic thing that people will tell me all the time is they're fermenting soy. Now, we talked to a farmer that grew organic crops, and he told us that the soy doesn't even need glyphosate sprays because he said nothing will go near it. Bugs won't go near it. Birds won't go near it. Bugs won't go near it. Cattle won't go near it. Deer won't. Nothing will go near it. It's such a toxic food. And he says when they spray the glyphosate on it, it's, again, to reap a stronger harvest. And the supposedly non-GMO soy's got glyphosate sprays on it, which, because they don't have to list everything on the product. They don't have to list the pesticides. They don't have to list the genetics on these products. They don't have to list the nanos on the products. There's nothing there forcing them to do this. So when you're dealing with some of the so-called food safety, this is why I'm encouraging people to start their own grow-ops indoors. You know, start developing your own grow-ops and start growing your own stuff indoors. Even indoors, if you take a scope and examine whatever you're growing, you will find that there'll be particles on your plants. That's how saturated the air is.
Okay.
And if you want to prove that to yourself, go get yourself a laser, red laser, green laser, like these green 5-megawatt lasers.
Mm-hmm.
Shut yourself in the room, turn off all the lights, make sure there's no lights on, turn on the laser, and what you're going to see is particle flex flowing through the beam. It'll be like a Tyndale effect when you're doing making your colloidal copper, colloidal gold, or your colloidal silver. It'll have to be the same similar effect where you'll see a beam being broken up by the particles. Same thing.
Okay.
That's how much the air is loaded. This is why I encourage people not only to awaken from the delusions, but to get very active in this.
Well, Tony P., you certainly are. Tony Pantelaresco, who every month on the second Monday of the month on One Radio Network, he will take you where no man has gone before. Yes.
From the Hill Country in Texas, this is OneRadioNetwork.com.
Patrick now, 888-663-6386, or email patrick@oneradionetwork.com.
Okay, Tony, we're going to start taking some emails, otherwise we'll be so far in the weeds, we'll need a lot of glyphosates to get rid of them. We'll have to get sprayed.
Yeah, well, and they will be either dropping their androgens and dropping their estrogens, and none of them will work properly, and then they'll be all mad at you for spraying glyphosate.
It'll just be ugly. Let's start with a phone call. What's your first name, and where are you calling from, please?
Yes, good morning, gentlemen. This is Robert in Houston. Hi, Patrick. Hi, Tony.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, John. Got two quick questions. One is about the sodium thiosulfate, and don't hang up on me. I got one for about question on a remedy for kidney stones. But first, curious, what'd you have for breakfast this morning, Tony?
Black cup of coffee with creatine, AMP, ginger, what is it, zinc, boron, and potassium mixed in my coffee.
That's yum, yum.
That's Tony P's bacon and eggs, baby. Okay. What's your second?
I'm finally going to try the sodium thiosulfate. So, quick question. I couldn't find it, but by the pentahydrate form, not the dry powder?
It doesn't matter. Either form will work. One's a crystalline form, one's a powder form. You can go to chemicalstore.com.
Yeah, it's a good company.
And they have both of them there. It doesn't matter which form you go with. Again, use a teaspoon of this stuff, mix it in water, add a teaspoon of ascorbic acid, mix them together. And make sure you're getting minerals and ferments in your system, because if you've got an alien up your backside, it's coming out. You know, that's all there is to it. And you're going to flush everything out, and you have to restore to the body the mineral content and the bacterial content, because like I said, you're going to be probably flushing out glyphosates. You're going to be flushing out. You're going to see things come out of your backside that you're going to just scratch your head and wonder how it got there. You may see fibers. You may see particles. You may see chips. You may see gooey material come out. You may see polymer material come out. I mean, and if you do it, try to do it for 4 weeks.
Every night for 4 weeks?
Every night for 4 weeks.
Whoa.
Do it before bed. Now, the other thing you may find, because I've had different people if you go on the YouTube and look at the video, not everybody reacted the same way. Some people didn't have any reaction for the first month, and the second month when they took it, they exploded like you wouldn't believe. Some had the stuff come through the skin. Some had no effect up until the second or third week, and then some, immediately it started working. And again, I will reiterate this fact, if you feel any kind of stimulation in the nether regions, where you think you're going to have a past wind, get up and immediately go to the toilet, strap on the seatbelt, and park your backside there, or you will have a mess.
Okay, Robert.
Isn't that dry powder more concentrated since it's not in a crystal form, so it's still the same dose, one teaspoon of the
It's probably just ground up things, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you can tinker with it. If you find it's too much, go half. But I think you're going to find it'll work either way. And again, I'd probably tell you use a teaspoon.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
This stuff is going to purge out your lungs, too. So.
Now, before Robert, your second question. Tony, you mentioned this sodium ascorbate or ascorbic acid. That's, you said, to protect the liver.
Yep.
And what if you don't do that? Is it bad on the liver?
You got to remember, you're flushing out a whack of poison.
Right.
It's going to go through the liver, and
could
it's going
you,
to detox the liver.
So could I, if I didn't want to do that, could I add, or we could add maybe a liposomal C with that?
You could.
Okay.
I mean, it doesn't matter. I mean, you can add milk thistle if you want.
Just something to keep the liver happy.
As you got to remember, I mean, I would probably, if you're not going to go vitamin C, I would even tell you use rosemary, because rosemary is a very strong, powerful protectant of the liver and poison, protecting the liver from poisons. You don't want to go that route. You can also use schizandra berry, which is another.
Oh, I got some of that. Okay, good.
You can go that route as well. Okay. I mean, the reason why I just...
Yeah, it makes it easy for people, the vitamin C. I understand.
Very easy and very inexpensive. And so, you can elaborate. Like I said, when I show you these things, I'm only showing you one perspective. It's not the only way.
Yeah.
You know, it's not the only way.
Many ways up the mountain. Okay, second part, Robert.
Well, real quick, just to follow up, you take the vitamin C at the same time as the
Mix them together and again, it doesn't matter how much water you want to take. If you want to chase it with more water afterwards, you can. The stuff is pretty horrid tasting. It does taste worse than manure. since I can't use the other word.
Yep.
So it is a taste to acquire, I got to tell you.
Can I tell you the truth why I'm really getting it? But then I figured I might as well take it. I wash laundry and use bleach. And bleach is so caustic, it'll tear the fibers. So I was trying to put borax in there to neutralize it, but borax don't really neutralize bleach. So after I do some whites, and you can never fully get it out, I'm going to put some of the thiosulfate in there to neutralize the bleach. That will, and that's one of the best bleach neutralizers, correct?
Yeah, that's what they use it for. I mean, try. I don't know if that will work that way, but give it a go. I mean, I don't discourage anyone from experimenting. And then when you do it, let everybody know your results. I mean, this is the only way we're really going to learn, right? Sharing things on a network like this, or with your network, your immediate network.
One at a time. Okay, Robert, second.
Well, one last on the TSP. Now, you said this will wipe out everything in your body, bacteria and all that. So what's the difference between, like, taking an antibiotic and wiping everything out and the TSP? Because you were saying on there
SPS is not an antibiotic. I wouldn't give an antibiotic to anybody. You'd have to have a rock in your head to use that crap. SPS will even pull out radioactive material out of the body, which your antibiotics will not do. It will pull out metals in the body that your antibiotics will not do. Antibiotics, in my mind, you've got to be, like I said, unless it's an absolute necessary, nothing else is working, you'd have to be literally an idiot to use
them. But answer his question, the difference between...
It's rolling out radiation.
Okay.
But
I mean the difference in cleaning out...
Not a big difference. There's no comparison.
Okay, no comparison. All right.
Okay, it's not going to kill the good bugs, you're saying.
Oh, it'll flush everything out. If you got, like I said, everyone's got glyphosates in the system, and glyphosates wipe out all the good bacteria, and your bacteria in the body can't break down glyphosates. So what's left is your E. coli, your fungi, and mold, and everything else that's in the system because the bacteria isn't there. So a lot of that's going to get flushed out. So you have to, this is why I'm telling you, you have to replace, if you're going to do this, you have to replace it with the bacteria, probiotics, yogurts, kefirs, sour creams, cheeses, stuff like this. You have to put that back in the system. You might want to use things like you don't really need quercetin, but you can use quercetin as well to help protect the colon. MSM protects the colon. Onions protect the colon. So these are things that you want to, because again, you're flushing everything out. So you've got to put stuff back in, and this is part of the cleansing products. Not only just taking the negative out, but you got to replace it with the stuff that is supposed to be there. Or you will wind up having...
Have you tried it yet, Patrick?
Oh, no, Robert, we really got to move here, because we got 100 emails.
Kidney stones remedy, Tony. I'm taking Chanka PI drip, and what should I know or what not know? Go ahead.
It works. I mean, I don't go that route. I just use citric acid, and that seems to work just as well. A Chanka PI drip, drink it easy. That's what it's called, Stonebreaker.
Chanka Piedra.
Okay, that's it.
Okay, thank you, Robert. Okay, hi, Patrick and Tony. I've heard there is a supplement called FOS, fructose, what is it, whatever that is.
Oligosaccharide.
Yeah,
the sugar that feeds the probiotics.
Easy for you to say. Believed is derived from inulin, which is in itself derived from chicory root. This supplement is supposed to be a fiber and a prebiotic. Having listened to Tony for years, I don't ever recall him mentioning. Is there any particular reason why you don't mention it, or is it worth taking FOS?
It's not needed.
That's why
I don't mention it.
And it's not needed because it's not needed?
It's not needed.
Okay.
I mean, if you're taking yogurts or any fermented dairy, it's going to have its own sugars in it to help feed it. I mean, and plus, if you're eating any fruit, you're going to feed your colon that way. You can use it if you like. I don't discourage it, but I don't see a real...
Could be an extra expense. It's not.
Yeah, I mean, I try to keep things simple where, unless you're really rich and you got money to throw away, go for it. But if you don't, like the rest of us, then keep it simple.
Is a commercial supplement titled Apple Fiber with Apple Pectin likely to be compromised with chemicals or stuff? Or can we use that?
Again, with the research I'm seeing today on the nano, if they don't take an eighth of an inch off the apple, then nanos are going to be in there. There's no way around it. Same with the pear. If you don't take at least an eighth of an inch off the top, you're going to be dealing with nano pollutants. Menopause? So, again, I don't know what to tell you on this. Again, I'm still doing my investigations. But, again, based on what I'm seeing, if it's not being clean, because you can't clean it with a solution. You can't use vinegar on this stuff to pull it out. This stuff embeds itself. So, again, I don't know what to really tell you on this. If I was going to use a pectin, I probably would either use a grapefruit or a citrus pectin. At least there you have a layer of skin, a thicker layer of skin on top, which would probably minimize any saturation. Let me put it to you another way. Everything you're going to eat today is going to have some kind of nano pollutant. I don't care what it is. You know, we've had nano pollutants since the early 60s when factories were pumping out nanoparticles with pollution. So you've got to have this in your system. So, again, things like I said, phosphorus and sulfur and minerals, liposomes, polymer materials that you can make, glyconutrients that you can make are going to go a long way as far as not only flushing this stuff out but restoring the body's biochemistry back to normal.
Mm-hmm. Tony mentioned one of the past shows about nootropics. Which nootropic has Tony used to be most effective in terms of prolonged energy and concentration? Are nootropics that elevate histamine levels, such as Adrafil, problematic?
The only ones that I use are, for myself, and the ones I've encouraged to use, and the ones I've seen the most results, is the combination that we put out is Piracetam, Choline, and DMAE. I've not seen anybody having any side effects with this, and in about the 10 years I've been putting it out there, and I've even had one account where a guy who had Alzheimer's, he was using that supplement with a thing called Aricept, and it reversed his Alzheimer's completely. So it was the only guy that I've ever had, and I have to say this, the only person that I've ever had tell me that, and I've got the medical report to back it up, that it's actually reversed his Alzheimer's. So, now, again, I can't say it will do this for everybody because, like I said, it's only happened one time. So I'm not making any claim on this, but you can try that if you have this issue.
Okay. Jonathan writes, I've been taking the sodium thiosulfate with vitamin C, 1 teaspoon each in water, periodically to detox, and was wondering if the SDS is hard on the liver or kidneys. Okay. I think you've addressed that. Also, it is okay to eat a little bit of food before taking the SDS and vitamin C combination.
It would be a waste of time.
Because it's coming back out, whatever.
I mean, why bother? Seriously, if you're going to do it, do it. You know, don't play around. Best thing to do, look, if you're trying to detox, you don't want to load up the system first with some kind of food or component and then take the stuff, because all it's going to wind up doing is your system, you're trying to remove crap out of the body. So why add more to your body to work harder? It doesn't make sense. So go, okay, you know.
Whatever.
I don't understand the thinking there. I mean, if you're trying to detox, you want to do it as much. That's why I tell you, do it close to bed, because you're not going to be eating anything, and so it has a more profound effect in reducing and removing stuff.
Mm-hmm. Hi, what's your question for Tony?
Hi, this is John and Dallas. How are both of you? My question for Tony is: I have a friend who worked in a dentist office for over a decade. Mm. And over the years, as she worked there, she began to notice that foods like lemons and tomatoes caused acid reflux. And she basically had a hard time eating red meat. Whenever she would eat red meat, it began causing really sharp liver pains, and then she began developing chronic bladder infections. And I've given her some of the Patrick's sulfur powder to basically maybe detoxify what I think may be, you know, a mercury issue from working in the dentist office. But whenever she takes the sulfur powder, she also gets the acid reflux burning sensation.
Hmm.
And I wasn't sure if there were any suggestions you had.
Increase HCL. Increase the HCL and start having her do baths with borax and baking soda. She's also probably got high levels of radiation in her body as well.
Borax and baking soda. Borax and baking soda.
If you take a bath in that, that will extract the radiation from the system.
Hmm. What's the formula? How much do you put in a bath, Tony?
Anywhere from a quarter of a cup to a half a cup of each.
Mm-hmm.
Dissolve it in the water and just make sure she takes it as hot as she can handle it and lay in it. Allow her body to completely be as much submerged as possible. That will help pull out the radioactive material. Again, I'd probably have her use increase the hydrochloric acid. How old is this woman?
Basically, is now 62.
How old?
62, Tony.
62? Yeah, she needs hydrochloric acid, and she needs probably to increase the proteolytic enzyme to break down the meat. Again, if she's having problems with meat, tell her to use another form of protein, whether it be chicken or duck, turkey, lamb. Something like that, and maybe the meat she's buying too, maybe the cut of meat, or maybe where she's buying it might have crap in it. It's a possibility, but I would definitely have her increase hydrochloric acid and either a pancreatic enzyme, and maybe start having to do teas, either rosemary and turmeric teas, which will also protect her from breast cancer as a way to block the estrogen and a way to protect the liver, and possibly have her drink cinnamon and juniper berry tea to help regulate the pancreas.
Okay. And will the juniper berry and cinnamon also help with the bladder infections?
The rosemary will help with that. The juniper
is supposed to be for kidneys, right? Her bladder.
Yeah, well, it's also for the bladder. It'll break down any infection in the urethra. So will the cinnamon. If she's having problems with that issue, like I said, it's not the meat that's causing it. That would be the grains that she's consuming, cereals that she's consuming, or the rice or pasta. I would tell her to eliminate that. Anybody that's in that age group that's in the 60s or born in either the 40s or the 50s, first thing I get them all off is the grains. And 90% of these issues, especially in the digestive area, in the reproductive area, usually clear up relatively quick once they get off that.
Awesome.
Okay, John, thank you for the call. Here's an email from, don't know a name. He's been experimenting using organic turmeric, Tony, and he's using fresh one. They chop up 3/4 of a pinky-sized piece of turmeric in my salad, about the same size of ginger root plus olive oil, sure. Black pepper, lemon juice. The rest of my salad sounds good, cucumbers and all that. Do you think that this level of turmeric I take is adequate, and would you suggest anything else to throw in this little monster salad that would help with my arthritis? Okay.
Turmeric works when you add black pepper to it.
Yes.
It has the curcumins in it, and they don't get activated until you add the piperine to it. So if you're going to do, it sounds like a good combination he's got. The only thing I might add to it might be rosemary, because it too is an anti-inflammatory and analgesic. And again, because you're adding turmeric with it, again, it's an estrogen blocker. It'll pull and excrete estrogens out of the system. And plus it also affects the brain. With the ginger, you're boosting your testosterone levels with it, so you got a testosterone booster right there. And again, I would add a little black pepper to it, and away you go.
Away you go. Roger's up in Wisconsin. Could you please ask Tony if one could create an essential trace mineral such as zinc, magnesium, and selenium using the same methodologies he outlined in his YouTube for making the copper compound?
Mm-hmm.
I can source fairly pure forms of these metals on the net, ranging 99.6% to 100% pure. Would that be pure enough, rather than buying from companies that have other
pure
ingredients?
Look at the MSDS on these things. When you look at the purity products on these things, whether they be food grade or industrial grade, I didn't see any difference between the food grade and industrial grade, for instance, of the iodine crystals. It was like 0.1%. And when you look at the MSDS on it, they're exactly identical. So that's what the first thing you need to look at. When you're buying any kind of sourcing any minerals or any metals that you're going to make whatever colloidals out of or solutions out of, look at the MSDS and look at the, not only are you looking at the purity value, but look at the whatever is in there that might be so-called toxic. Sometimes it's nothing, or it's in such small minutia, I don't worry about it because I can take a sulfur or some other chelating agent to pull it out of my system, because there's a lot of things you can take to pull out of the body. For instance, magnesium will flush out aluminum, sulfur will flush out aluminum, sulfur will flush out lead, it'll flush out mercury. You got a lot of things. Phosphorus will flush out things as well. Salt, simple salt will flush out and detoxify the brain and remove, toxic materials out of the body. So, don't get caught up on the minutiae on things when you're making stuff, because you're probably already eating things like, for instance, garlic, onion, leek, chives, watercress, other vegetables that also have chelating agents or protective agents, or you're drinking teas, for instance, that have high levels of antioxidant properties that protect you from some of these things. So if you're doing these things and you're making things to, again, augment your health in some form or fashion, and if there is a potential problem, then come up with a countermeasure to it. You're not living in a perfect world, and you're not going to get the purity concept. Like I'm just telling you, you're exposed to high levels of nano, so everything is going to have some kind of contamination. Even after it's been processed, even in the way they process things, there's going to be some kind of contamination. So all the vitamins you've been taking over the years, all the supplements you've been taking, have some sort of minutia in there that would be of some contaminant value. Oh, and I want to talk about one thing real quick.
Okay.
Okay, magnesium stearate. Everyone,
yeah, because that's in everything, right, Tony? All these supplements have magnesium.
Harmless, okay, inert material.
Great. Well, I'm glad to hear that because I've seen it in things that I wanted to try, and I just stay away because of it.
But this is what irks my ire. No,
irks your ire. I can tell.
Say the other thing.
Okay. Don't you can't say the other thing.
What happens is when you actually look at magnesium stearate, all it is stearic acid, which comes from tallow.
Tallow?
Tallow.
Beef tallow?
And magnesium is magnesium. And both the stearic acid and the magnesium are required by the heart to function.
All right. So don't worry about magnesium stearate.
The things you need to worry about, and this is, like I said, these gurus that come up with this horse hockey.
Horse
hockey? They need to be flogged and hung on out to dry. I'm not kidding.
I am Henry VIII. I am. I'm flogged and...
I don't know. I would. That's a beheading. No, I wouldn't behead them. I just make them feel the pain for the bullshit they've been putting on the
market.
Tony,
don't say that word now.
Bullshit. I didn't say the other word.
Yes, you did. You can't say that S word on the show.
Oh, I know. I didn't say it.
Oh, you didn't. You said bullshoy?
No, I just said bullsh. That's it. Nothing
oh,
more.
Bullsh. I see. I didn't.
Bullsh.
Okay. Okay. Sorry.
I didn't say that.
All right.
I respect your house. I don't say what you don't want me to say. I just said bullsh.
Bullsh. Okay. All right.
Okay. Anyway, when they come up with this crap, what they've done is they distracted you from the other components in the vitamins or the nutrients that you should be looking at, like the cross caramelase and the polymer material, because that's what's neutralizing the effect of these pills or the aluminum lake or the titanium dioxide. They're not talking about this. Oh, no. They've completely avoided, but they picked on magnesium stearate. And magnesium stearate's been in these supplements for 50 years, and I've not once seen anybody having a problem with magnesium stearate. So now what's happening is everyone's all petrified and paranoid about buying a product because it's got magnesium stearate in it, and it is a benefactor to the heart. So this whole dichotomy to get you to look at that instead of, okay, titanium dioxide. All the males that are buying products that have, especially these bodybuilding products, titanium, it causes testicular cancer.
Oh, great.
These nano silver products causes testicular cancer. Anything nano is going to have a negative effect on the body.
Speaking of nano, Lisa says, are nanoparticles created when using a jewelry cleaner to make liposomal vitamin C?
I don't think so. I think you're more in a micron measurement there. The vitamin C is a powder. The other things are powdered. They're dense enough. I don't think you're in a nano level at all. When you're talking nano, and the dangerous levels of nano that you got to be concerned about, really concerned about, is between 1 nanometer and 50 nanometers, because this penetrates everything. The way the liposomes are working, basically, is they're penetrating the fat or attaching themselves to the fat and it being absorbed through the liver. So when you're doing it this way and it gets into the cells, it will actually help the cells fight or flush out, because this is a phosphorus material. So again, if you wanted to add a mineral composition to it, let's say you wanted to add magnesium, calcium, zinc, selenium, iodine, manganese to it, because this is what the glyphosates flush out, you're going to essentially put these things back in. If you want to add salt to it, again, you're going to make a more potent detoxifier, especially for the brain, because this is the other thing that irks my ire.
Irks your ire.
Not to use salt, because salt is a detoxifier of the brain and can keep the brain from getting tumors.
Hmm.
So when they tell you that you've got too much on the blood pressure thing, this one drives me up the wall. If you are not above 200 on the BP, you're fine. If your range is between 120 over 70 to 140 over 90, you're fine. You will not die. If your blood pressure even goes up to 160 or 170 over whatever, then take another reading 2 hours later. Because what's happening is your kidneys are flushing out toxins. So at that point in time, your blood pressure is going to go up, because it's what it does in order to flush the kidneys of the toxins. And then within 2 hours, it should be back down to normal. So if you're taking a BP reading, you have to do it twice within a two-hour window to get an accurate reading. So when you go into a doctor and he says, oh, my gosh, you're going to die of a stroke. Oh, you're going to die of this. And you know, one, they're not God. Two, it's a lot of horse hockey.
And three, I think it's fair to say that most people going into these very sterile environments, clinics and doctor's offices, are they're not very, well, you know, they're not the easiest
place.
They're
not user-friendly.
They're not user-friendly, and people kind of, they could raise their blood pressure 20 points just walking in the office.
Yeah, and that has happened. I'll tell you a true story.
Yeah.
True story. I got people here that I've helped in Windsor, and a doctor told him that his blood pressure was high and his sugar was high, because they do the measurements here are a little different here for the sugar. They do it in single digits instead of in hundreds. Anyway, he was at 13, which he says the only way you're going to get that down is through medications. And so for a year, I got him off all the grains. He didn't touch any grains, any bread, nothing. He was drinking unpasteurized milk. I had him eating all the fat he wanted, all the fat he could take. So cow fat, cream, butter, you know, we'd go out to eat, and he'd buy a steak and eat the fat. Anyway, he went to the medical office, but before he went in, he went to a restaurant. He had a steak, had tons of butter on his potato, and a black coffee. Went in, got tested. His sugar levels were down at 7, and his BP was 120 over 60.
That's great.
And so this was to show the doctor, number one, that he was FOS, and number two, that you could do this without drugs, and even the nurse said, you ate all that and this? She says, yeah, look what the readings are. And you know what? This is another myth, and this is, because I get people contact me all the time through the email, my blood pressure is low, and they're literally crapping themselves. And I was like, they're normal. One guy called me up, wanted a consultation, and he wanted me to give him something for his blood pressure. I said, where is it? He said, well, 140 over 90. He said, well, you don't need nothing. He said, what are you going to give me for my blood pressure? I said, nothing. You don't need nothing. And again, I'm telling you this, it's straight out. And again, the research on this whole thing with cholesterol, when you're eating any grain or bread, oxidizes, and it's trying to protect you from the dangers of these things. And with this genetic crap and this stuff, this is why you might have a problem. So leave the grains and breads and pastas and rices alone, and guess what? Your cholesterol will go all by itself. It's going to do anything. Don't need a statin or anything else.
Well, I like to keep my cholesterol 225.
Yeah, that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. And that's where you should be. But again, you go to a doctor, he's going to go, oh, my God.
Oh, my God, yeah, that's going to push
you. Oh, man, your cholesterol. Oh, and they give you this song and pony, and it's a lot of nonsense.
Yeah, okay. Tony Pantelaresco, this is Patrick Timpone, OneRadioNetwork.com. We got a good show for you tomorrow. It's going to be fun. We're going to do, let me get to it, just so I can, oh, sorry. Oh, man. Okay. I lost the broadcast code, and I got it back. Janice Barcelio, I hope that's how you say her name, we'll find out. Ecstatic Birth, and it's pretty cool, some of the things that they're doing. And David Noakes, he's going to be helping us to understand GEMAF. You've heard about that, GEMAF, and I think the Nagalase thing we'll get into. Tony probably knows more about it, but I'm not going to ask him because he's not going to get all the emails, and then we'll be in trouble. If you'd like to go to Iodine Source, which is the Edgar Cayce kind of website that Phil Thomas has put together. I said kind of because Edgar Cayce's got nothing to do with it, or his relatives or anything like that. It is just this study that Phil Thomas has made of Edgar Cayce's readings over the past. He's been studying for 20 years, and Edgar Cayce, I think he had about 25 or 30 years of readings. One of the things I will tell you for sure, virtually in every case, Edgar Cayce put people on castor oil packs, almost all of his patients. He'd say, go home, taught them how to do a castor oil pack on their colon, their intestines, and do this every other day for a week or a month, depending. Pretty powerful. I've been playing around with it. It's very, very powerful. Iodine Source has little castor oil packs that he's made up for you that are no mess. He's got organic ozonated castor oil. He's got regular organic castor oil. He's got the packs. He has sulfur salts, which is a pretty cool little combination that Edgar Cayce came up with. That is cream of tartar, Epsom salts, and sulfur, and helps to detoxify the thyroid from all the goobies, and helps it make it available to take up the iodine. Pretty interesting. Cayce figured that out 100 years ago. Mm-hmm. He knew about that thyroid. And then you can get some of the agricase iodine, the atomized iodine, and very inexpensive. These both products you can get on Iodine Source, the sulfur salts and the iodine and the castor oil and other fun things on Iodine Source through OneRadioNetwork.com. I wouldn't sweat it, though.
Here's health motivator Daniel Vitalis and the benefits of using a far infrared sauna.
Sweating is absolutely going to be one of the most critical things discerning people take on so that they can not only stay healthy, but actually so we can continue to have children that are healthy. We're going to need to sweat. People have sweat all through history. Before the world was toxic, they used that for their health. Now that it's toxic, it's one of the only ways we're going to cleanse our body fat. Our body fat is where we store so much of the environmental pollution. Not just the radioactive elements, we're talking about PCBs, we're talking about plastics, we're talking about a host of pesticides and herbicides, talking about heavy metals. Getting this stuff out of our bodies, we're going to need to sweat it out.
And a fast, easy, and affordable way to sweat is with a portable, relax, far-infrared sauna. See all the information. Order with promo code ONERADIO on OneRadioNetwork.com, a relaxed, portable, far-infrared sauna on OneRadioNetwork.com.
You can forget that thing about promo code. You don't need that because that commercial's a few years old, but it's still viable information. Just no promo code needed. Just order away.
There is no America. There is no democracy. There is only IBM and ITT and AT&T and DuPont, Dow, Union Carbide, and Exxon. Those are the nations of the world today. The world is a college of corporations, inexorably determined by the immutable bylaws of business. The world is a business, Mr. Beale. It has been since man crawled out of the slime.
One nutritional secret is that due to soil infertility, plants are not making the percentage of mineral sugars that they did before the advent of chemical agriculture. These mineral sugars are measured in the juice of a plant. The more sugar, the more minerals, proteins, fatty acids, vitamins, and phytochemicals. According to some experts, these mineral sugars are what activate the DNA of our body to be efficient at making protein. Due to an absence of enough of these mineral sugars in our plant foods today, our bodies require 40% more protein. One World Whey is a technologically enhanced whey protein food that can supplement the protein needs of your diet. It is easy to assimilate and it tastes delicious. However, its most attractive feature is that people from ages 3 to 80 are having phenomenal improvements in health. People are reporting vast improvements in energy and well-being that last for 4 hours or more from a single serving. You can click on the One World Whey banner ad and order right here at OneRadioNetwork.com. That's OneRadioNetwork.com.
We are listener-supported. One Radio Network. Talk to Patrick now. 888-663-6386. Or email patrick@oneradionetwork.com.
Tony, I played that thing about business just for you.
Yeah, well, you know what? That was so true what it said.
And that's from the movie Network. Have you ever seen the movie Network?
I'm mad as blazes, and I'm not taking it anymore. Yeah, that was probably the truest thing ever said.
I know.
That movie was done when? In the 70s?
76.
Yeah, I mean, they were basically telling you the way it really is.
The way it's going to be, man. Yeah.
It's a good movie to watch. Yeah. I don't know if you ever watch it.
Which one?
Lord of War. Have you ever watched that?
Lord of War. I don't know that one.
Go watch it sometime. If you really want an eye-opener how the planet is run, that will show it. And I was really surprised.
Really?
That, that will tell you exactly what's going on in this whole arms game, who's doing what.
Oh, you mean, yes, I have seen Nicolas Cage.
Right. And yeah. You will not.
I've seen that, yeah.
That tells you basically, this is the way it really
that's
is.
That's the way they do it, man.
There's two sides of this planet. And the side that we see is the fantasy, and the reality side is what the business, like they said, the world is a business, and that's all it is.
It is a business. You know, Tony, we've been taught by Andrew Goss, who, longtime friend, that back in 1860, in this country, when the South was, going to secede from the Union, right? Lincoln attacked them because they were putting tariffs on their cotton, right? It was all about money, right? And the Lord Rothschild, he gave each side one side to his one son, one side to his other son, and they financed each side of the war.
Well, the French I was financing it, and so were the British.
Oh, yeah, they were all in there.
It's the same thing in Canada. Canada's been a...
You guys are a mess. You guys are a bigger mess than we are.
I don't know about that anymore. We were.
You had your moments.
We're attached to the United States, so whatever happens there happens here, or vice versa. Sure. Whatever happens here happens there. These are two prototype countries, and we're not even countries anymore. We're corporations, the Corporation of Canada and Corporation of the United States. And this is why the whole system of government in the United States and Canada is a farce. You know what? I'm going to say something that is really interesting. When the United States government by far is the best government on the planet. But you know how to neutralize the American government? You take the people out of the equation. Because everyone's been taught that the three branches of government are the checks and balances of the government. That is a lie. That was the biggest lie ever perpetrated in the educational system. The check and balance in the United States is the people of the United States, because when the Constitution was written, it was written for the people, by the people, of the people. So the check and balance is actually the people of the United States, not the three branches of government. Because once you separate the people from the three branches of the government, you got a rogue government, because they're just going to be in each other's pockets. They're going to be in cohesion with each other. And this is why the United States is in the problems it's in today, is because the people have been separated from the government. Canada never had this. No other country in the world had this check and balance like the United States. And now that, too, has been completely radically neutralized. And I wouldn't be a bit, because the presidents that you have not been elected, and they've been appointed, just like our prime ministers and every other prime minister in the world. The banks appoint whoever's going to be in there. You pull the lever and it goes to whoever they want in there. So a lot of this is because it's a corporation and it's being run as a corporocracy or a fascist government. So that was a true check and balance of the American system. And that's why the American system was so unique, and nobody on the planet had anything even remotely close to it until they started taking the people out of the equation. And that's been going on since Kennedy.
Yeah. And I think both of our countries have some real pretty deep ties to the Queen, as well as the Vatican, that not too many people know about.
A buddy of mine just found out the other day, and I've been telling him for years, that $1 trillion of U.S. taxes goes to the Bank of England. And he found out that 40% goes to the Bank of England, 60% goes to the papacy. This is why the Pope has come to visit Obama.
He wants more money.
He's going to collect his money.
What's the money? Can you boost that? Oh, well, we won't go there anymore. I would like to try the tea on your video for hot flashes, writes Marie, because I'm not sure of all the ingredients needed. Can you give me a list, or is it just better I go back and, or do you have them?
They're listed on the, I don't think I put them on the, I might have put them on the YouTube recipe video. You can go click the link there. If not, I'll put it up.
Can you give her a short list now, or is it too complicated?
Yeah, it's a lot. And then and she can go and click it on and just download it.
Okay, so the YouTube video has all the ingredients listed?
You listed on the More tab, and if it's not there, if she goes on my website, okay. That website with the web link that I just showed you, YouTube recipes or YouTube remedies.
Augment and Force.
Yeah, it'll be in there as well.
Augmentandforce.50webs.com, right?
Yeah.
Tony, and then you can get the list of for the hot flashes. And what are hot flashes, and why do some girls not have them and some girls do?
The reason why some women don't have them or don't have them as bad is because they're having sex regularly, and the testosterone from the male is balancing that out. And the reason why a lot of them are having them is because of the high levels of glyphosate in their diet, which is disrupting their endocrine system. Or they have an overload of estrogens in the body as a result of eating soy and pea proteins and rice and all this other crap. So again, they have to sort of do a detox on the endocrine system and flush that out. And again, the SDS will do wonders in regard to that. So
hot flashes are a toxicity issue.
Yeah, basically the body is breaking down. You got an overload of some sort of hormone in the system. Usually it's an estrogen.
Mm-hmm.
Attaches itself to the system. So when the body goes into a heat or a fever, it's trying to burn this out. So again, when you
That makes sense. Yeah, so it's like a fever.
Yeah, it's a fever. It's trying to burn it out.
I'll be done. Never heard that. That analogy before, that's interesting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Because that's what the body does, doesn't it, Tony, when it wants to get rid of something or will get warm?
If it can't flush it out through the endocrine system, lymphatic system, or whatever, then it goes into a fever.
Mm-hmm. Do you ever recommend, do you think it's a, a viable, reasonable look-see at these bioidentical hormones?
A lot of bioidentical hormones are not bioidentical. They're actually pharmaceuticals. So you got to really be careful. And if you do use any of these things, I mean, the biggest... Okay, I just did a thing on the show last week, and they've tied a lot of the hot flashes to a hormone called pregnenolone.
Pregnenolone.
Okay, now, what they found out, the women who have the higher amounts of hot flashes are low in pregnenolone. They also found that calcium also helps offset the hot flashes. Now, don't go crazy and take tons of calcium, because that's not going to work either if you overload the body with calcium, small amounts. But, I mean, and the other thing that I've been talking through the show, hinting very strongly, is rosemary and turmeric. Pour them in combination, make extracts out of it, and start using this. These are anti-estrogens, and if using iodine in conjunction with this, the iodine is actually what converts the estradiol to estriol to estriol, which allows the estrogens to go out the door. But when you combine rosemary and turmeric, these are the two most, they're extremely powerful anti-estrogens, and they affect the brain, making the brain more effective. They protect the liver. You know, and they are very powerful antioxidants. They help, again, with the blood flow and the supporting the brain. You couldn't get a better combination, and a cheap one.
Yeah,
very
cheap. We have a very, very nice turmeric formula on our site that has black pepper, and as you said, it really needs black pepper to work. It's in our store on One Radio Network. What can you recommend a rosemary product that you've used that you would be comfortable with?
All I use is the straight stuff. I either buy fresh at the store or I buy...
Of course, you know, we can't freeze rosemary in Texas. It's against the law. So how... I still got that huge rosemary bush. So if somebody grows some rosemary, how do they get it into their body?
Basically, you can make a tea out of it.
Just make a tea?
You got the Everclear down in Texas. That's 190 proof.
Oh, don't tell me you're going to do this formula because it doesn't work.
Well, no, you don't have to freeze that one.
Okay, go ahead.
Don't say it doesn't work. It doesn't work for you.
I know. I just can't freeze it. But go. Okay, so you take fresh rosemary.
Because that's what is 195 or 190 it's proof, which is basically 95% alcohol.
Okay,
so, I mean, I would use that instead and do the same process that we showed you before. You don't have to freeze it. And once you extract it, strain it, and then away you go. And then what I would do is I would use a teaspoon of that and do the same thing with either a turmeric powder or fresh turmeric.
Yeah.
The only thing that I would add to it means I might add a little black pepper with the turmeric. So when you're extracting it, the black pepper's already in it.
Yep.
The activator of it.
Wow.
Take a teaspoon of each, put them in a shot glass, mix them up, down you go. You do it several times a day.
And that is a very anti-estrogen, right?
Huge.
Huge, and that'll really help guys boost their T levels.
Not necessarily boost the T levels, but reduce the E levels. Yeah, I don't necessarily want to boost my T level.
I see. Okay.
I want to sustain what I have, and I don't want it to be blocked with estrogen. So if I take the estrogen out of the equation, then my T levels will be more normal, or where they should be. Because, again, if you increase testosterone, it's going to convert to estrogen. So if you're low, that's not a problem. But if you're already at a good level, then you don't really want to go up too much higher because you're going to have an estrogen issue.
Gotcha. So you could just mix up the Everclear with the fresh rosemary and just, that's it.
Yeah.
Mix it up. Okay, and that's it. No. Don't have to worry about freezing it.
Yeah.
Because I said, you know, there is a law against that in Texas. Thanks so much for all you do, putting my questions out. What are Tony's thoughts on bone broth? This is from a lady in Sydney, Australia, Tony. Is it a good thing to make and have it on this day and then the next day too?
Yeah, it's excellent.
It's good, right?
I talked to somebody from Colorado,
yeah,
and they had a meter where they tested the fluoride in the bone broth and found that the fluoride levels were very high.
Oh.
And I said, well, that's probably because of whatever the cow was eating got caught up in the tissues or in the bones.
Or maybe they use tap water, too.
Yeah, that too. Maybe she... I don't think they use tap water. Yeah. I think they used distilled when they made it.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, again, if you've got this going on, it's in the system, it's in the cow, and again, sulfur and iodine remove fluoride out of the system. So again, if you're taking adequate amount, you have to understand, in today's time, you're going to have to start thinking countermeasure. You don't assume under any circumstance that you're getting some kind of purity product or something that's orgasmically organic or whatever alternative cliche they're using. That's all marketing. You know, there are a lot of good products out there. Chances are they're going to have probably some trace amounts of contamination. Chances are, though, you can neutralize those contaminants very easily. So again, don't be all worked up, because I hate just giving you bad news without giving you some sort of solution. And these are solutions that I'm giving you that do work. So you are not living in a perfect world. As the recording stated, you're living in a world of business. So when you're looking at your health, do not rely on any guru. Don't even rely on me. Seriously, you need to start looking at things on your own level, investigate things. I mean, if you need my help, I'm not in opposition of helping you, but I don't want you to become reliant on me either. You need to take care of yourselves, and you need to learn how to take care of yourselves. And you need to investigate, learn how to investigate. And the one thing I always tell people is don't go to a DARPA search engine. That's what Google is. It's DARPA. So you're not going to get to the information that you
should be getting there. Let me stop you for a second. Yeah, we have heard that I think Google, as well as Bill Gates, somebody who has said on the show, they were actually financed by the CIA.
Or DARPA.
So what's the connection between Google and DARPA?
The information you're getting is coming from DARPA. It's not coming from whatever. So whatever they're putting out there, at best, will be half measures. I mean, there are so many search engines you can look at.
What's your favorite one?
You can type in a search in Yahoo or Quirtle.com, PubMed, whatever, and you can go from there and just look at their search sources, which are university studies or industry studies that the actual industry is doing, which would be far, far, far more reliable than going on any kind of DARPA search engine. So, again, you know, when people say they do a Google search and this is what they find out, majority of the time Google is telling them some sort of horse hockey that doesn't really have any relevance to what they're looking for. So, again, learn to use your wits on the searches.
All right. Tony previously mentioned that he does take some things sometimes to protect from chemtrails. Can you ask him to go over that?
The biggest thing you're going to need are your minerals, your antioxidants, things like sulfur, things like phosphorus, vitamin C. You're going to need to, again, boost the ATP levels in your bodies, because your ATP levels are being burned out as a result of the overloading of the nanoparticles on the cellular level. Your mitochondria is being burned out. So, again, we've got, if you go on that site, the anti-nano site, you will see a whole list, a whole variety of components to boost your ATP as well as support your mitochondria. It's extensive. What I use in the morning for myself, I'll have a black coffee, which they find also protects you from your ocular from having any damage. I may have my rosemary and my turmeric first thing in the morning as well. I'm using ginger in my regimen now. I'll add my coffee will have AMP in it. I'll put straight AMP. I'll put creatine in it. I will put potassium chloride in it. I will put potassium citrate, some zinc. I'll mix a little maple syrup with it. And then the tea itself will have hawthorn leaf, which, again, provides ATP protection and blocks any estrogens. And I'm always mixing this formula up. So maybe I'll add a little rooibos one time, or I'll add some other herbs. And I mix up the herbs all the time. Maybe I'll add nettle root, again, to support the liver and the blood, as well as, again, for testosterone. And then, you know, I'll drink that first thing in the morning. Usually when I eat a meal, I'm like between 12 and 15 hours between meals. I don't feel the need to eat. I'm finding I don't need to eat like I used to. I find that when I do eat, because of what I eat and the nature of how I mix my stuff, and even how I cook my meats and stuff, I'm good. And I don't eat huge portions like I used to either. And, again, that could be part of the aging as well. It also could be a psychological thing, because the more stuff I see, the less I want to eat. That kind of thing.
Okay, we're going to have to bring you down here to Texas and fatten you up a little bit. All right.
I don't need that.
Okay. Good. What's your first name and where are you calling from?
Hey, this is Jimmy from Texas.
Jimmy from Texas. You're on the air with Tony from Windsor, Ontario.
Hey, boss. Enjoying the show a lot. I have been the last month discovered I've become really, really clumsy, and I've been doing some searching on it, and I just forgot the term that seems to imply I drop things, I knock things over, I bang my knee, I bang my elbow, I bang into things, and this is a recent development of the last month. just about every day. I bang my left elbow on things that never did before.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, Tony, what could that possibly be?
Aluminum poisoning.
Aluminum. All right. Where would Jimmy have got this aluminum?
It's not uncommon. A lot of people are having this problem now, again, because you've got the saturation reached whatever point. Okay, start using things of sulfur and B1. This will also help pull lead out of the brain if you have anything there. You want to use saturated fats to regenerate
the nerves, right?
Cellular integrity of the cells, as well as nerve endings and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Serum oil will go a long way there to oxygenate your cells. If you have a chance, go look at the site, look at the augmented force site, look at the anti-nano. Make yourself that, what I call the anti-nano chamber, which is basically a bucket wrapped up with about 96 windings of 12-gauge wire. Get yourself a power source, a laptop power source, connect it to your wires. Add in the solution, either straight vinegar and salt, and maybe a little citric acid, and put your feet in it, or dilute it with water 50-50. Let your feet sit in there for a half hour and do this for a couple of days and then see what happens. You may find that you'll be rebalanced again. Like I said, everybody's getting saturated here, and a lot of this is because the brain and the body are now becoming disconnected. So before you start using anything like a nootropic, again, start using lecithin. Again, it's a phosphorus. It does help regenerate the brain cells as well with the choline and the serine and the ethylalamine in it. Any saturated fat would help you. Butter, cream, sour cream, cheeses, yogurts. Make sure they've got fat in them and they're plain.
So this is a somewhat of a classic kind of symptomatic things for aluminum poisoning.
This is I'm saying this all the time. I've had this happen myself, and I realized what it was, and immediately I started flushing the stuff out. And again, we're all becoming saturated, like I said, through the. I mean, I'm showing you the fruits and stuff and the food, even wine. Like I said, I did an extraction component yesterday with it, and I saw the nano just floating to the top. So we have to, like I said, reevaluate what we think is a clean source, because nobody is going to list on their product they've got nanoparticles or they're using nano adjuvants in the food.
Well, Jimmy, I hope that helps. Does that help, Jim?
Yeah, I will study this when it comes online.
And grab some of our sulfur and give it a try and see if that doesn't help you as well.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jim. All right. Bumping into things. Wonder if Tony has any thoughts on healing a small pinpoint cavity that is developed on the front tooth from Gail.
We got that tooth regenerator video. It seems to work for a lot of people as far as, again, getting rid of the cavities. But on the same token, eliminate the grains. And I'm not giving you any exceptions to the rule here. All of them, rice, corn, wheat, barley, soy, get rid of the soy as well. No canola oil. That's another thing that's causing the guy's problem. If he's using any kind of canola oil, this breaks down the myelin sheath and the cellular integrity. They should not be used. Omega-3s. Oh, one more real quickie.
No, you got time. Go ahead. Take your time.
This bologna.
Bologna?
Fermented fish oil.
Fermented. Oh, yeah. It's a fermented cod liver oil.
This is complete bogus. Bull roar. There is no way, number one, you can ferment oil. What is a fermentation process? Fermentation process is the breaking down of sugars into alcohols and then into vinegar. Where is the sugar in the fish oil? There is none. Very little to even ferment. I've got a 114-page report. I've been saying this for 3 years, that the omega-3s and especially this fermented crap is not what it's cracked up to being, and it's a big farce. When you eat this fermented fish oils, I'll tell you, it's going to help regenerate teeth and all this stuff. It will actually break you down further. What's going on is they've got a lot of this fish oil that's going rancid on the shelves in their warehouses, and now they're turning it around and dumping it into the health food industry, calling it a so-called healing food. It's not. It's poison. It actually toxifies the body. If you are on this stuff, dump it. Don't even put it in the field. It's just crap.
Tony said that, not me. Ross in just kidding. Ross in London, London, England. What would Tony suggest for someone who has been exposed to organochlorine compound called ketone, a.k.a. chloroquine. It's an insecticide related to Myrex and DDT. I may have been exposed to it on a significant level in the 1980s after living near a chemical incineration plant. I've noticed that some people are now in the low-lying areas in the local area have developed cancers at a frequency faster than other places. Wow.
Sulfur.
Sulfur. All right, sulfur.
The vitamin C, sulfur, and B1. Get them going in the system, you know.
Okay,
like the guy said earlier, it's an anti-bleaching agent. Mm. It's to pull that stuff out. So I mean, sulfur.
So my next question, yeah, so folks that get on this organic sulfur, a couple of things that really kick it up a notch would be vitamin C and B1. Why? What does B1 do?
Well, B1 is your power vitamin, number one. Number two, it pulls lead out of the brain.
Oh, good.
When you add sulfur to B1, it augments the effect of B1 by a factor of 13.
Wow.
So you got a very powerful amount of B1 in the system. And again, we're talking sulfur and vitamin C for glutathione buildup as well. And again, a powerful detoxifying and protective agent. So you've got, you know, it's a real simple solution. Just use some sodium thiosulfate with vitamin C and, again, regenerate the body by putting in the bacteria and the right nutrients, and you should be relatively good.
Okay. This second part of Ross's question says, I've been making my own mineral citrates, including zinc citrate. I've noticed that zinc citrate can sometimes give me a feeling of nausea, and it doesn't taste that great. Can Tony think of a way of adding something to the zinc citrate which will prevent the nauseous feeling?
Taking too much. You can put glycerol in it to take the edge off the taste, but you're taking too much. Whatever you're taking, really, you got to remember, zinc in small amounts helps your body. Zinc in high amounts will poison the body. Same with selenium. Selenium in small amounts benefits the body. Too much will cause a problem. Same with manganese. Same with chromium in small amounts. This is when you are taking these things, they're usually in microgram strength, unless you've got a health issue that warrants a higher concentration. Like, for instance, selenium, if you want to use 1 milligram and divided doses throughout the day, not a problem because you're using it in a mineral source. If you're using zinc, same thing. If you're taking too much, then you're getting a nausea, it's just too much at one time, you need to back off.
Okay.
Back down.
If you had one general source, zinc source, what would you pick? Like, what kind of zinc?
You go to zinc source. I would either use zinc citrate or zinc picolinate or zinc methionine.
Okay.
Any one of those three.
Zinc citrate or picolinate.
For zinc or scorpion.
And what's a reasonable daily dose?
Again, depending on what you got going on. I mean, if you've been taking for...
just for general overall zinc.
Probably about 30 milligrams or 30 to 50 milligrams a day. If you've got something going on, then obviously it's going to be a lot higher depending on the issue you got going.
Mm-hmm.
So, but yeah, 30 to 50 milligrams a day would be more than adequate.
Okay. All right. Hey, guys, I'm wondering what Tony's thoughts are on hives. What are they? How do we get them, kind of get rid of them?
Hives is usually a...
detox of some kind, maybe?
Not necessarily. It could be, but hives is usually a form of herpes.
Herpes, I'll be darned.
So basically, lysine, zinc, and olive leaf is what I give most people. And again, the lysine is 500 milligrams, zinc is about 30. And the olive leaf, basically, I usually give it in an extract formula or teas to get a stronger uptake. And again, they would be doing it 5 times a day or 6 times a day for a couple of days. And then once the conditions go away, then maintain a daily dose. Eliminate any kind of seeds or nuts in the diet. Because if you're eating high levels of arginine, it will exacerbate this. You'll keep imbalancing the lysine levels.
Huh. What are some of the other uses, Tony P, that you have used with olive leaf extract?
I've used it for testosterone building. I've used it for fighting viruses. I've used it for fighting bacteria. I use it for circulation issues, for antioxidant problems. It's got a lot of healing properties.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Mm-hmm. Could you take it semi-regularly or regularly if you were can you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, with any herbal remedy you use, I mean, I use them for a short time and then get off of them.
Right.
So your body doesn't acclimate to them and then they don't work anymore. But, I mean, for a short interim, I mean, anywhere from 1 to 2 months, I mean, I do something and then get off and change it to something else and give your body a chance to, you know.
Kind of regroup, yeah.
Well, you know, or relax or whatever. Because some of these things do have a tendency to pump you up kind of thing.
Yeah, yeah. With the price of food rising, economic collapse possibly, and the deleterious effects of some foods, what do you recommend we stock up on?
Anything that's going to penetrate the cells, to flush the cells, anything that you're going to, again, maintain good spleen, kidney, and liver health or detoxifications. Anything that's going to be utilized by the brain, again, for detoxification. You got to remember, nanoparticles, when they get inside the body, lodge themselves in the brain, the skeletal structure, the cells, the liver, spleen, tissues all over. So, you know, we are constantly being inundated with this. So things, like I said, sulfur is number one. Sulfur is up there, phosphorus, salts, mineral salts, these are key. Anything that's fermented that's going to replace the general bacteria. Saturated fats, omega-6 fats, not threes. Threes will actually accelerate the damage of the cells. This has been another pile of rubbish that they put out there. You know, the health food industry has always been an industry that's accepted the mainstream's leftover and called it healthy. So be aware of this. Be seriously aware of this. I keep things very fundamental, very easy, very cheap, very inexpensive. Herbs you want to, again, maintain are rosemary, sage, thyme, savory, oregano, the stuff down in your neck of the woods, that rosemary and that, if you have oregano growing in that area, are extremely powerful. They're more so than what we got growing here because of the nature of the environment. I would be using things like cinnamon, ginger, galangal, again, to detoxify the colon and to help support the pancreas. Anything you can do to support your pancreas, I would suggest you do it. Again, minerals like zinc, manganese are big, big, powerful insulin regulators. If you have a compromised pancreas, then you got to regenerate it. So you use bitter melon. You would use Siberian ginseng. You would use juniper berry. You would use neem, peppermint, cinnamon, clove, these bay leaf, fenugreek. These all have powerful healing restorants or supportive mechanisms to support your pancreas. You know, any amino acids that you can get from gelatin or a good whey protein that doesn't have anything in it other than whey, and whether it's an isolate, concentrate, casein, I don't care, as long as it's clean, use it. I'd have you use eggs, lots of eggs. If you could eat a dozen a day, I'd tell you to eat a dozen a day, and then what I would do is put on the egg, I would sprinkle rosemary powder, sage powder, nutmeg to enhance the brain functionality. This is a nootropic that you're making using the egg as a brain food. I would be using unpasteurized milk if you can get access to it. You can get access to somebody who has a cow. Try to make sure they're not feeding the cow soy. And again, I would add either wheat germ oil to it and then raw egg to it. And this is the best bodybuilding superfood supplement you can buy anywhere on the planet that will actually rebuild your system. You want to add a little gelatin to it to increase the biological value of the milk and egg protein. You can do that as well. So there's lots of ways you can add a little wheat germ oil to it. Now you got a brain thing going on as well. So you've got lots of ways to do it. So these are things that I would do and keep it simple.
You mentioned three spices with the eggs, rosemary, sage. What was the other one?
Nutmeg.
Nutmeg. Wow. That sounds good.
Yeah.
Is there like raw eggs?
You can do that too if you want. Again, if you're doing raw eggs, make sure you incorporate biotin. And if you want to whip the egg and add these, again, powders or extracts in them, then you will create a liposome. So then they then drink it down. Liposomes are so easy to make, and you can do them with almost anything, with creams, with eggs, with sunflower lecithin. You know, and again, sunflower lecithin powder is the simplest way to do it, really.
Sunflower lecithin powder. An emailer says that the green pastures, which is one of the more popular fermented cod liver oils, does not ferment the oil. They ferment the livers.
It's, again, protein, fat. Where's the sugar? Come on, smarten up here on this. It's a toxic, spoiled oil. That's all it is. Do not use it. It's just crap. Again, another thing that's been used in the marketing gain to sell you a byproduct or a waste product in the mainstream industry. Don't get duped on this.
Don't. Okay, Patrick, this question for Tony. What is the best thing ever to support, maybe even regenerate failing kidneys?
Oh, vitamin A.
Vitamin
B5. Tyrosine. Dandelion root. Nettle root. But again, it's the diet. It's the thing you got to look at. You know, what are you eating? You know, using canola oil, using soybean oil, or using vegetable oil, or using grains. You got to change. You got to drop this.
It's the 14th of September. Tony Pantelaresco, he's here the second Monday of the month. Got a couple more, and then we'll let him go back to work. Ask Tony about the blender breaking up the balloons, like Troy Hippas says when he makes liposoma in a blender.
Hey, again, showing you another way. The powder will not get the balloons. And it doesn't matter if you get the balloons. It's just an air pocket, nothing more. Don't get caught up on this stupid minutia. You are creating a liposome by creating what they call a bilayer. You're doubling, you're basically surrounding a component in the fat. That's all you're doing. All this other stuff is just a lot of rhetoric to make them look more important or special or whatever the heck it is they're trying, or to market their product. Unnecessary. And again, if you do the powdered format, you're not going to get the bubbles on this. You will not get it at all.
Do we need to take the liposomes concoction on a empty stomach so it'll go right to the liver?
It'll work either way.
Does it?
You can do it that way and then take your food afterwards, but it'll work either way. It's a food.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So even if you have food in your stomach, it'll still work.
Yeah.
Okay. Any suggestions? Here's an email. Erin says she has dry eyes, and you can please repeat how to get rid of gray hair. I don't eat grains, sugar, processed, or GMOs. Erin in Los Angeles.
Okay, basically what you need is a copper. Copper gets rid of gray hair, and then again, it's tied to the eyes as well. If you got dry eyes, then you may have a copper deficiency going on. So again, and that would be a result of the chemtrails and the nanoparticles in the air and the food you're eating, which would deplete the copper in the body as well as the glyphosates. This is one of the things that glyphosate does, is strips copper out of the system. So when you're looking at gray hair, you're producing a lot of peroxides or peroxide, and copper neutralizes this. Your body is, again, in a it's at war internally trying to keep you alive and fighting, and peroxide is one of the methods that it does use to do this.
And so, that makes the hair gray because it kind of bleaches it.
That's right. Mm. So what you're doing is you're depleting it because you've got a copper depletion as
right.
well.
And what's your favorite copper supplement?
The one I make.
Oh, what about if you wanted to buy one?
Chlorophyll from Bernard Jensen.
That's right, chlorophyll, right, of course.
But the natural one, not the flavor. The flavor, I don't know why they put crap in the flavored one, but the natural one is a good one. It's got nothing in it. One teaspoon gives you approximately 5 milligrams a day.
And that's good.
And I was up to taking 25 milligrams of copper a day, and I never saw any side effect with it. So all this hoopla about 2 milligrams of copper, because you're going to wind up with copper poisoning, it's a lot of baloney.
Natural
but you must take zinc with it. You have to take some form of zinc to keep it balanced. Majority of the population in the United States and Canada are copper deficient. They're not getting their copper. And a lot of these algae products, like blue-green algae and spirulina, they actually deplete the body's copper as well. So, again, be careful when you're using some of the so-called algae products. Algae acts as an anti-copper. So when you're using formula, taurine, copper and zinc for the eyes, and then I probably have you use more vitamin A and vitamin B2 to get that back, and I'd probably have you start using either a saline wash or take some MSM powder, dissolve it, and use that to wash the eyes to remove some of the nanoparticle buildup, because that's what's going on. You got a lot of nano in there, a lot of aluminum that might be drying the eyes out. And the taurine, copper, and zinc will help, again, work as an antioxidant to flush the metal particulates out of the eyes. You may notice if you're on that formulation for a week or so, your vision may even clear up a bit. So basically, that's what you would use. And if you want to use a shampoo, get some Castile soap. Add your colloidal copper to that. Add some rosemary essential oil and some coffee. And shake it up and wash your hair with it. Give it a couple of days, and you'll see the gray hairs all go away.
No kidding.
Yeah, try it. You'll try it. Patrick, you look like a 25-year-old available male waiting to go on a date by the time you're done with it.
Well, I look like that now.
Well, you look even better then. You look like a 16-year-old ready to go out there and...
Really? Really? Sharon has to just tie me down, you know.
Yeah, she'll be having a billet club to keep everybody away from you.
That's great. God love her. Okay, let's see. There are a few questions for Tony. I have been detoxing heavy metals for a year and a half now, and I'm finding that my candida seems to be getting worse and worse as I pull the metals out. It is hard to determine now if my symptoms are more related to heavy metals or candida. How do you safely detox heavy metals while still keeping candida under control?
Are you putting any bacteria back in the system?
I'm not sure.
That's the question.
Okay,
we're detoxing metal. Okay, that's great, wonderful.
Okay.
But candida is also part of the body's defense mechanism. So if you don't have enough healthy bacteria back in the system, then the candida is just going to take off because there's no check and balance. So, and again, if you're eating any kind of grain still, well, you know, basically you're eating a mycotoxic food that has high levels of glyphosate, nanoparticles, and a whole host of other things. You have to understand that nanometals, even if you shut down the nanoprogramming and if things rise to the surface, you still have to pull this stuff out because this stuff will still penetrate and bypass the cells and it will start saturating the body with heavy metal poisoning on a cellular level. And so you have to, when you're pulling this stuff out, you got to put back the normal stuff back in. You got to put stuff back in, like I said, it's going to support the ATP to keep the cell's respiratory system up and running. So as long as you're detoxing, because this is the other thing you were told now, right? Gluten-free bread. Gluten is a protein, will not feed candida whatsoever. It's the sugar molecules in the bread that cause the problem. And if you're eating a gluten-free bread, you are eating a genetically engineered bread because when you take the gluten out, you've genetically engineered the gluten to be out. It's a protein, all it ever was. It's been altered through genetics. So, again, there's no part of the grain or bread that's of any real value. And it can still take up to a year or several years to get this out of the colon as long as you're leaving the glyphosates inside your system. This has got to be flushed out or you're going to constantly have problems.
Okay. Do we have any more? Oh, yeah, Mike. I think we could cut a couple more. Let's see. Thoughts on enlarged prostate from Ross in Leslie, Arkansas. Wow. Leslie.
Go to Walmart, take the prostate out, get a regular one put back in, no more problems.
It's cool. Yeah, but see, it's made in China, though. That's the problem.
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
It'll break down eventually. Just go get another one. No problem. Cayenne, aspirin, and magnesium.
Cayenne, aspirin, and magnesium.
That's what I give everybody, and guess what? The prostate shrinks, the inflammation is
no
gone.
No kidding.
Now, the other thing is this, too. If you're eating foods, again, that have artificial flavoring agents, natural flavoring agents, you're eating anything from beaver anus to soy to aborted babies, anything that with these components must be avoided. You're not to eat anything with soy or pea proteins. These are all highly estrogenic. Rice, grains, got to be gone. You don't change the diet, this is going to be a forever reoccurring issue. Now, when you start using these things, we actually got a formula. Well, we got a formula in my catalog link. I've actually put a formula together now because I decided I've been giving it out for so long. I may as well see if anybody's interested and they can buy it. And basically, the formula is already put together. I've even got two formulas. There, one's with EDTA. You can use either one for the prostate issue, and one doesn't. So for those who might be, it might be too overwhelming. But that would carry it through the system, get it where it needs to go. It'll help, again, flush out the aluminum with the EDTA because the magnesium is there with it. And you've got, because magnesium also increases ATP production. ATP.
ATP.
So, again, when you combine the two, three together, the cayenne, aspirin, magnesium, it has an anti-inflammation effect. It reduces that. And if there's any cancer in the prostate, aspirin and cayenne both take it out.
It's pretty amazing.
Yeah.
You kind of had me at beaver anus, I got to say.
Well, that's what's in it.
When you
see a product that says natural flavor,
yeah,
this is what I'm saying. They don't have to put a full disclosure on what these things are. I mean, what is a natural flavor? What does natural flavor taste like? You know, I mean, there is no such thing. What is an artificial flavor? What does that taste like? I can tell you what a lemon tastes like. I can tell you what an orange tastes like. I can tell you what an apple tastes like. I can tell you what meat tastes like, you know, because these are actual products that have a flavor to them. But what is a natural? You don't know. What is an artificial flavor? You don't know. So when they're putting, you know, aborted baby proteins into this thing that they've, you know, because, again, this goes on. Nestle's was doing this. Campbell Soups was doing this. I don't know if they still are, to name a few companies. This is why I tell you, people, don't support Nestle's. That company should not be supported. They're stealing the fresh water from North America, shipping it over to China. They should be hung out to dry. I mean, best way, and this is another thing I want to say real quick. Everyone says to me, what can I do? I'm just one person. What can I do? You got the power of the dollar. Don't support these companies. Quit buying their crap. The only way you're going to hit a planet built on business and make any change is not going to be through a political spectrum, because they're all bought and paid for by these corporations. It's through the power of your spending. You know, when you quit buying all Nestle's products, you're sending a strong message to them that you're tired of their nonsense. When you quit buying all of Monsanto's products, you're making a strong, and doesn't take a lot of people. You know, even if just Texas alone quit buying Nestle's products, I'm telling you, that would cripple them. Huge. So, and this is why I say everybody needs to not just sit on their backside and just listen to programs like this and your other stuff, but they need to take an active role in this, you know. And one person can make a difference, you know. I always tell people, read the story about David and Goliath. It only took one person to make a difference.
He was a good shot.
He was.
What does Tony think about algaes like spirulina, chlorella, blue-green algae? Are they beneficial, or should we stay away?
Good for fertilizer.
You're not a fan of any of these green guys?
Nope.
Because?
Because they deplete copper.
They do what?
They deplete copper. I had a guy...
Why do they deplete copper?
An algae. That's what algae does.
Oh.
Now, I had a guy up in the UK, and he did the SDS and decided to use a vegetable juice to stop it. And one guy in Portugal was using some kind of moringa or whatever.
Moringa.
Yeah. Moringa for their mineral content. And I told him, I said, when I made this thing, I didn't say use these things. I said use an actual mineral supplement. Because when you're using an actual mineral supplement, it's got a ratio that you can understand that you've got a consistent mineral value. With these other things, you have no idea what's going on. So they'll give you a list of all these things in these algae products, but you really have no idea. And the big thing, that the big sale on spirulina was it had the B12 content. What they forgot to mention was that B12 content is in minutiae amounts, and your body can't break it down to absorb it. So there's a lot of hokey-pokey with this as well. I mean, they forget to tell you certain facts about some of these things, you know.
And then they started breaking the cell wall, and they said that is the reason why, right? Have you seen that? Cell wall broken. Broken cell wall.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Okay, let's put it this way. I don't use them. I don't endorse them.
Okay. Okay, one final question, and this ties right into copper. How to handle a copperhead bite for a person or a dog or a cat? Wow.
What kind of what?
A copperhead, you know, like a snake.
Oh.
A snake, like a poison snake. Any ideas?
One of the things they used to do is use high levels of papaya enzyme.
Really?
Yeah, because the enzyme breaks down the protein in the venom. Now, there's another thing you can do. Something just came out this week, and I've been playing, but by taking copper and hydrogen peroxide, you amplify the effect of the antibacterial by 3,000%. So this is something you might also want to spray on the thing. But, yeah, I mean, if you got something like that, dog bites and stuff, the first thing I would be doing is I'd be just pumping high levels of vitamin C, and I'm talking 3 to 5 milligrams every 2 hours, and I'd be eating papaya enzymes or a high enzyme like serrapeptase every half hour.
Yeah.
And then I'd get you to a medical facility.
Quickly,
because, again, that can make a big difference from this stuff spreading in the body. And by the time you get there, I mean, one guy got bit by a scorpion in Arizona, and it took 45 minutes to get to the hospital. And so he was chewing these things every 10 minutes. And by the time he got to the emergency there, the venom was gone. There was no trace of it.
We have a really cool, it's my vet, holistic vet, on Thursday, and I'll save this question for him as well, and that's on Thursday, Dr. William Faulkner. Well, Tony, we probably offended as many people as we could in 2.5 hours, so I guess it's time to go.
Hey, it wakes them up to get them active. I don't feel bad about the offense. I mean, it's not about offending people, and you know that as well.
I know that.
Making everybody aware. So, and not only aware, but, you know, you can make a difference, and this is what. And then when we do these videos, and the theme about these videos is you can make these things, you can make them better. I'm starting you off on a venture of investigation so that you can now have at least a leaping point when you go on my webpage. We always tell people that you can, download anything off the page. It's totally free. We don't need your credit card. The word free is what it is there. It's free.
Like really free?
Yeah, really free. You can watch the YouTubes and learn from these things. And again, everything that we're showing you on the tubes is not the only thing to do or the only method. It's just one method that I am showing you to get you started on, again, investigation, exploration, and experimentation so that you can take care of yourselves. Do not rely on any guru. Do not rely on anybody. Rely on your wits, your thing. If you're not sure about stuff, then you start to learn. I mean, this is where it is. You have to start to learn, and develop your own niche in these things, and you'd be surprised how much you will learn and what you will be able to do.
Well, Tony, I don't know if I agree, because I was at the place getting my oil change in my car, and in the lobby they had this little TV, and I watched the TV thing, and it told me to ask my doctor. So I don't know. I believe him. All right, kiddo, thanks a lot. It's always fun. His website is augmentinforce.50webs.com. augmentinforce.50webs.com. And then YouTube, just put in Tony Pantelaresco. He's got about 1,213, whatever, a lot of YouTube videos. All right, you stay out of trouble, brother.
All right, thanks for having me on.
Okay, kid, bye-bye. Tony Pantelaresco, he goes where no man has gone before. He does. That's why we like him. Okay, kids, we're out of here tomorrow. We're going to be birthing ecstatically. We'll also talk about that GCAM, whatever that is, Nagalase. I knew the word there. I had it a minute ago and lost it again. Oh, it's GCAM. Which empowers your body to cure itself. We're going to find out how to get it, how to develop it, how to buy it, how to go on the internet, or whatever else we do. Thanks for everything, Sharon. Hope you enjoyed the show, and we'll see you soon.
Broadcasting.